on the blood of our
heroes. Blessed art thou, Yehovah God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. In Yehoshua's name we come before you, O Yehovah, even in these last days, as the children of Israel, Most High, giving testimony that you are righteous, that you are just, that you are merciful, O Most High. And we come here even as the descendants of even our ancestors who were slaughtered in this place, asking and begging for righteous judgment upon Babylon.
In 1863, man, we thought that we was free. Fighting the war, we know what it was to hit the street, so we spread the rumors. We told all our families, we gathered the old folks and the children and hit them leaves. We were walking and running, cause they said that we'll be free. Just go down in this hole and if you make it, then you will be up north with the free folks. We you chill and you eat folks. I didn't know what it was, but somehow I did say some eat. But what's the war with these heathens? We know where it could have been. We know if we made it up out this hole where it should have been. So we took to the streets. You know the rumors spread it real fast. We told all the Hebrews, you know we made them happy. From mama to grandmama, everybody in this hole. At least the amount that we can get to go. And that's 20,000. Man, this hit out of control. It's been 6 months. How the hell we getting this devil's punch? Oh.
At night, O Most High, and hold themselves not guilty. They hold themselves innocent, even as they shed the blood of our sons, of our daughters, of our elders, Father, of the young and of the old, of the weak and of the strong, O Most High. They have shown no pity. They have shown no mercy.
When the slaves were released from the plantations and the occupation, they overran Natchez, and the population went from about...
Democracy set you free. The Natchez didn't feel the same. They slaughtered and murdered us. We wish we were still enslaved. They'd rather be picking cotton than rotting their life away. Infested with smallpox. Corruption would never stop. While working around the clock, they buried you where you drop. You planted us like we crops and hope that we never sprout. But Yah has a final plan. Deliver us from this land. He never intended for us to be destroyed by the hands of man. Kidnapped our souls. Kidnapped our soul. The devil punch bowl.
Devil punch bowl.
Still in existence under FEMA's control.
FEMA's control.
Rex 84.
Rex 84.
The king got for plane.
King got for
these crackers are plotting. I hope Yah Hebrews are praying. For mercy, screaming for grace, preparing your soul for what you destined to face.
In the face,
13 elites, the mark of the beast. I'm spiritually grinding, giving our praises to thee, Most High.
Even the blood of the saints who were slaughtered, even by the whore of Babylon, as she becomes drunk off of the blood of our people. Oh, Yehovah, have mercy on us. Even gather the remnant of Judah and of Israel together in spirit and in truth. Remove even the divisions, O Most High God, that keep us from coming together. And let us come together in love and forgiveness and unity, Most High, and in faithfulness and in obedience, in submission, in spirit and in truth. We just pray on behalf of our people, Yisrael, O Most High, that you would cause us to stand in these last days. Give us strength, O Yehovah, for the Ruach HaKodesh, your Father, O Yah. Pour out the latter rain, O Most High. Show mercy unto us. Deliver us, O Yehovah. Open the gates of heaven unto our prayer. Yehoshua, receive our prayer. Oh yeah, receive our prayer. Heavenly Father, let our prayer be as a sweet incense before the altar of thy throne, O Yah. Remember us. Remember the covenant that you made with our forefathers. We repent. Forgive us, O Yah. We have transgressed. We have dealt iniquitously. Our men and our women and our sons and our daughters, we are all guilty. But we repent with the whole heart. Forgive us, Yehovah. Deliver us, Yehovah. Pardon our transgressions, Salak Panu. Forgive us, O Yah. Deliver us from this bondage, O Yah. From this evil, from this pain, from this oppression, from all this terror, day and night, O Yehovah. Hear us, O Yah. Deliver us, O Heavenly Father. Yahushua, forgive us. But we have slaughtered you. We turned you over to the enemy. And we hope that we serve you in spirit and in truth. And that our sacrifices and our bondage and our oppression is compensation for yours. Oh, Yah. We know that you have waited for us longer than we have waited for you. So have mercy on us, O Most High God. Cause the house of Judah to stand. Cause the house of Israel to stand, O Most High God. And as we stand, bring down the adversary. For Jacob means the supplanter, O Yehoshua. So to supplant and grab the heel of Esau, we must be on the ground, and we are on the ground. Now, help us stand up, and as we stand up, let us take the heel of this oppressor and slam him into the ground, Most High God, and let him go into the pit. Let him go into the devil's punch bowl. Let him go there, Most High God. Bring righteous judgment on Yehoshua.
Blessed art thou, Yehovah God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. In Yehoshua's name, we come before you, O Yehovah, even in these last days, as the children of Israel, Most High, giving testimony that you are righteous, that you are just, that you are merciful, O Most High. And we come here even as the descendants of even our ancestors who were slaughtered in this place, asking and begging for righteous judgment.
In 1863, man, we thought that we was free. Fighting the war, we know what it was to hit the street. So we spread the rumors. We told all our families, we gathered the older folks and the children and hit them leaves. We were walking and running, cause they said that we'll be free. Just go down in this hole, and if you make it, then you will be up north with the free folks. When you chill and you eat, but I didn't know what it was, but somehow I did say some easy. But after war with these heathens, we know what it could have been. We know if we made it about this hole, where it should have been. So we took to the streets, you know the rumors spreading real fast. We told all the Hebrews, you know we made them happy. From mama to grandmama, everybody in this hole, at least the amount that we can get to go, and that's 20,000. Man, this shit out of control. It's been 6 months. How the hell we getting this devil's punch bowl?
At night, O Most High, and hold themselves not guilty. They hold themselves innocent, even as they shed the blood of our sons, of our daughters, of our elders, Father, of the young and of the old, of the weak and of the strong, O Most High. They have shown no pity. They have shown no mercy.
When the slaves were released from the plantations and occupation, they overran Natchez, and the population went from about...
Democracy said we're free, but Natchez didn't feel the same. They slaughtered and murdered us. We wish we were still enslaved. They'd rather be picking cotton than rotting their life away. Infested with smallpox, corruption would never stop. While working around the clock, they buried you where you dropped. Your planet us like we crops and hope that we never sprout. But Yah has a final plan, deliver us from this land. He never intended for us to be destroyed by the hands of man. Kidnapped our souls, kidnapped our soul. The devil punch bowl, devil punch bowl. Still in existence under FEMA's control.
We just pray on behalf of our people, Yisrael, O Most High, that you would cause us to stand in these last days. Give us strength, O Yehovah, for the Ruach HaKodesh upon us, O Yah. Pour out the latter rain, O Most High. Show mercy unto us. Deliver us, O Yehovah. Open the gates of heaven unto our prayer. Yehovah, receive our prayer. O Yah, receive our prayer.
Shabbat shalom, everybody.
Shabbat shalom. Shana Tova, that means Happy New Year's in the language of Hebrew, our native tongue. We greet y'all and are so grateful and happy to be here to share this Shabbat day with everyone, man. What a blessing to be here with the panel, my brothers and my Isha and my son. And we're just grateful to share this new year, this first Shabbat of the new year. How about that? All praise to the Most High. Yes. For giving us through another year, man, over hurdles, underwater, over fire, and breaking through ice, breaking barriers, man. All praise. Hallelujah, man.
Hallelujah.
It's been a most incredible season and a most incredible time. And now we're coming to a new year.
Hallelujah. Where
an opportunity to actually enjoy the increase. All the seeds that we've sown in the last year will bring forth this year. And we can't be happier. We can't be more appreciative and more grateful for this. So, you know, we just like to thank and honor the Most High Yah. So I'm going to say shalom to the panel. What's going on, everybody?
Shalom.
Shabbat shalom.
Amen.
Shalom, shalom, everybody.
Yeah. Good to be here, Rocky. Good to be here, family. Looking forward to this study. It's going to be exciting because you know how the subject of the calendar, everyone's got their own opinion and stuff like that. So really looking forward to hearing what the Most High is going to reveal through you, Ark. So yeah, it's going to be amazing.
Well, we're going to get into this word today, and we have something special to reveal to the body.
Yes.
All praises to Yah. Oof. We have the completed drum roll. Enoch calendar for 2024. All praise to the Most High Yah. Hallelujah. 2023-24. This is the original calendar from which all other calendars came from. And this is the 10th year anniversary. 10 years since the Most High has given this calendar. All praises to the Most High. And he has beautified this calendar. He has beautified this thing. And
hallelujah.
This calendar is more than just a calendar. This is a collector's item. And this is actually a history book and pictures. This shows the history of the nation of Israel, of the creation of the 12 patriarchs, their births. We included the birthdays of the 12 patriarchs as mentioned in the book of Jubilees. And we have the martyrdoms of the 12 apostles, all of the 24 elders that surround the throne, which is the Maserot itself in heaven. So we're going to talk about these things, and we're going to bring forth to light some new revelations and understanding, and we're going to compare it to the lunar calendar, the new moon, and we're going to see what scripture says, what is the Enoch calendar for all of our new viewers who are new and just understanding time itself that we've been lied to. We've been lied to by who? Who have we been lied to by, y'all? Tell me. I want to hear what y'all think about this.
The fat girls.
Well,
huh?
The fat girls.
Why y'all say that, man? Man, it's like, man, y'all just go straight into this stuff, man. Like, you can't get a job, man. Like,
that was a setup, man.
Man, so who deceived the world?
He looked like a video game guy.
How did time and seasons change to begin with? Who was behind it all? Who, you know, so we kind of wanted to discuss who did these things and why these things happened and who changed history so that they could change the present. If you change the history, then you change the present. And if you change the present, then you change the future. You know, his left eye looked like it got something in it, so I was just pulling it up a little bit, you know. So all of these things we're going to talk about today. All praise to the Most High, y'all. Y'all ready to talk about this?
Yeah.
Man. Cain, hallelujah. We're going to start with some prayer. Are you ready, my son? Hold on 1 second. Let me just change the screen. We're going to give all praise, esteem, honor, and glory to the Most High, y'all. Mikamoka ba Elim Adonai Yehoah.
Who is like you among the mighty ones, Lord Yehoah?
Ki ata barata kol devarim.
Because you created all things.
Natata ha luach min hakodem.
You've given the tablets from the beginning.
Cain. So tablets or calendar. Same word. Cain. Natata ha luach min hakodem.
You've given the calendar from the beginning.
Katavta kol devarim. Bereshit.
And you've written all things since the beginning.
Well, yadata kol devarim hasof min harosh.
And you know everything, the end from the beginning.
Ki ein Elohe kamoka.
Because there's no God like you.
Laquakta Aved Kakanok Lashamayim.
You translated your servant Enoch to the heavens.
Wahareta Oto Koldivari.
And you showed him
Cain. Well, Aved Kakanok Katav Koldivarim Besefir.
And your servant Enoch wrote all things in the book.
Wakol Ha'idomim.
And all of the Edomites.
Satru. Satar, to hide.
Hid.
Ha'emet.
The truth.
Mabene Yisrael.
From the sons of Israel.
Where Sarafta Ha'seferim.
And they hid the books.
They burned the books. Cain. What Otam Hashmid Koha Torot.
And they destroyed all the Torah.
Aval Natata Lanu Kolahem Opa'am.
But you've given all of them back unto us.
Bahayamim Ha'akrim Hazeh.
And these very
Hallelujah. 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 Dabarka Tamim.
Your word is perfect.
Cain. Dabarka Ha Zadik.
Your word is righteous.
Wenatata Toratka Le Avedka Moshe.
And you've given your law to your servant Moses.
Well, Moshe Natan Ha Torah Le Yehoshua.
And Moses gave the law to Yehoshua.
Well, Yehoshua Leko Ha Shoftim.
And Joshua to all of the tribes.
Mm-mm. Judges.
Oh, judges.
Well, Ha Shoftim Le Nabi Shemuel.
And the judges to the prophet Samuel.
Cain. Well, Nabi Shemuel Natan HaTorah LeDawid HaMelech.
And prophet Samuel gave the Torah to King David.
Wa'ata HaShoresh David.
And you are the root of David.
Cain. Ben David.
The son of David.
Yehoshua HaMashiach.
Yehoshua
HaMashiach. Asher Natata Lanu. Koha emet bahayamim ha'akrim ha'ele.
Which gives us all of the truth in these last days.
Hallelujah. Toraya ki zakarta habrit im avedkar Avraham.
Thank you, Yehovah, because you remembered the covenant with your servant Abraham.
Wagam le Yitzchak wa Yaakov.
Also to Isaac and Jacob.
Wakol yeladehem.
And all of the children.
Cain. Kol ha-satanim.
And all of the devils.
Lo yakolim la-asot ma-shehu aladot hahu. Well, kol ha-shadim ha-goyim lo yoklim la-asot ma-shehu aladot.
And the devils and the Gentiles cannot do them?
They can't do anything about it.
They cannot.
Hallelujah. Toda Yehovah. Toda Yehovah. Toda Yah ki natata lanu lashon ivrit gam kain.
Thank you, Yehovah, because you've returned to us our language again.
Wa akshal anaknu korin ha ivrit.
And right now we are, you say korin?
Kain.
Right now we are speaking Hebrew.
Kwara.
We are.
Reading.
Reading Hebrew.
Cain. Well, midabrim ivri.
And speaking Hebrew.
Well, kotvim ivri.
Kotvim.
Katav.
And we are writing Hebrew.
Cain. Well, shuv ta kol ha devarim ha ele lanu opa'am.
And you've returned to us all the things in these last days.
Bavakwisha Yehoah.
Please, Yehoah.
Shuv lanu ha bina yashar.
Return unto us the upright covenant.
The upright bina, understanding.
Cain.
Le halua kanok.
And the calendar of Enoch.
Wakol hazman.
And all the time.
Cain. Le habdil ha moadim shel Yehoah me ha moadim shel ha olam.
To understand the signs and times of Yehoah from the signs of the world.
Hallelujah. Tain lanu kakma.
Give us wisdom.
Lahaskil ha'emet.
To discern the truth.
Amen. Lidabir ha'emet.
And to speak the truth.
Em koak.
With power.
Amen. But Hayamim Ha'ele Hazot.
In these very last days.
Torah Yehoah Ki Ata Rofenu.
Thank you, Yehoah, because you are here.
Tirafenu Bavakusha.
Heal us, please.
Makol Makola.
From all disease.
Came. Makol Kole.
And all sickness.
Amen. Watain Lanu Beria.
And give us
health.
Health.
Bagufenu.
In our bodies.
Tain Lanu Dam Hakaves.
And give us the blood of the Lamb.
Likhasot Kataenu.
To cover our sins.
Amen. Waketov Bitokenu.
And to write within us.
Cain. Levav Shalem.
A whole heart.
Ledaateka Baruakwa Emet.
To know you in spirit and truth.
Amen. Mod Anaknu Modim Laka.
We praise you.
Ki Ata El Rakum.
Because you are the God of compassion.
El Shaddai.
The Most High.
El Elyon.
The God Almighty.
El Gibor.
The God of power.
El Zadik,
the righteous Elohim.
Wa Ein Elohe Kamoka.
And there's no God like unto you.
Wa Hasatan Histakaway Lefaneka.
And Satan bows down before you.
Cain, wa Kol Malachiah.
And all of his angels.
Wa Kol Devarim Yesh Lehem Nefesh.
And all things that have soul.
Yishtakawu Lefaneka, Lekol Hazman.
They will bow down unto you for all time.
Baruch Shemka Akshal Tami Leolam Va'ed.
Blessed be your name now, henceforth and forever.
Toda Yehoah Lashana Tova.
Thank you for this year.
Lashana Kadash.
This new year.
Bashem Yehoshua HaMashiach.
In the name of Yehoshua, the Messiah.
Hallelujah.
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 Amen. 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 You was going to say something, Maury?
No, I just enjoyed the prayer.
Oh, praise God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Man, we just thank Yah. And we are going to say shalom to all the family who's here. And then we're going to get into this excellent study today about the Enoch calendar. Hallelujah. Go ahead, Casita.
Shabbat shalom, family. And I can officially say Shabbat shalom because night of the time change is not almost dark.
Okay.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We're so happy to see everyone. Happy to have my brother Obenyahu.
Gang.
I told y'all this is my brother that never sleeps.
Gang.
He is on call.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So we love you dearly.
Amen.
And my brother 1611.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And everybody. We want to remind you that you can support the ministry one of three ways. It's scrolling at the bottom of your screen. But you can support via Cash App, $KaiYeshua, via Zelle, KaiYeshua@gmail.com, as well as on our website, www.KaiYeshua.com. Select tithes and offering and click that yellow donate button. We want to remind you, you need to visit HebrewIsraeliteScriptures.com after Shabbat is down, where you will see the new calendar.
Yes. Let me show the people as you explain this. Hallelujah. The 2023-24 Enoch calendar.
Yes.
Hallelujah. 10 years in. All praises to the Most High. Hallelujah. Before the year 2013, there was no Enoch calendar. And we prayed and fasted and sought the Most High for understanding the calendar. And he delivered it to us and told us that it was actually a clock. And when he gave this understanding about this clock, I heard this voice and everything came together. And Yah gave forth the understanding from that year, 2012, actually. And in the middle of 2012, and then when 2013 came, that's when we started the calendar in March of that year. And we are going to give an explanation and detailed explanation about how the calendar operates, and we're going to compare it to the so-called new moon calendar and where that came from and what scripture says about the new moon calendar. And we're also going to give y'all a look at the book of Jubilees, because we have to read from Jubilees today. In addition, we've completed all praises to the Most High, the book of Jubilees. Where have we got the book of Jubilees? Let me see. Oh, man. I got so much stuff here. Oh, Cain. Hallelujah. The book of Jubilees is here.
Hallelujah.
All praise to the Most High Yah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Book of Jubilees, the Hebrew English version. This is a Paleo Hebrew special edition of the Book of Jubilees that you cannot find anywhere else on earth. Hebrew and English for the Book of Jubilees, filled with pictures of our people. All praise to the Most High Yah. Detailing the times. Hallelujah. The Book of Jubilees is all about the times. Jubilees means a 50-year season of freedom and liberation. And this is the season when Yah is restoring these things to us. This is going to be a fantastic year for the truth and for the people. Hallelujah, in the year ahead. And we have now created the Book of Jubilees. And we have Sefer HaYovelim. That's the Book of Hebrew, Jubilees in Hebrew on the left side. That's what Brother Tyrone gave an excellent suggestion. And we have the corresponding English on the right hand side. All of these things can be found on our website, HebrewIsraeliteScriptures.com. This is the Paleo Hebrew edition where the name of the Most High Yah is found in biblical ancient Paleo Hebrew, along with the Strong's numbers, along with direct quotes from the Old Testament in royal blue. We have here in the first chapter where it says, "Come up hither unto me on the mount, and I shall give thee two stone tablets, the Torah tablets, and the commandments that I have written to teach them." That is a direct quote that's in Hebrew in the Book of Jubilees, that's in the same Hebrew in the Book of Exodus, chapter 24 and 12. These are direct quotes, family, as well as precepts that match the Old Testament. We have precepts here in Isaiah chapter 30 and 8, Deuteronomy 26, 32. We have New Testament precepts. We have precepts here in red representing the New Covenant, the New Testament from the Book of John 15 and 20. And then we have precepts in purple representing the lost books or the apocryphal books, 1 Maccabees 1, 43 through 49. We have all of that in Hebrew and in English. And the best part, should I show them the images, the pictures? Maybe just one?
Just one.
We'll give y'all a sneak peek, man. Gonna blow your mind. How about this? Man, look at this. It pulled up right on one of the good. Hallelujah. And this thing is so high def. Oh, man. Read that in Hebrew, son. Can you see that? Do I need to raise it up a little bit?
Yeah,
you see it on the lower right-hand corner?
Oh, Yaakov
with Esau, man. This is when their father made them swear a brotherly covenant, which brotherly covenant was broken. And all of this can be seen in the Book of Jubilee when Esau broke the brotherly covenant of his twin brother, Yaakov. So we got Yaakov with Esau. Man, should I show him one more? Just stop here. Should I stop here? I'll stop here. All praises to the Most High Yah, Abraham, Yitzchak, and Yisrael. We got that was before it, so I got to scroll back. But oh, family, when we get into this book, man, this book is historic. Oh, man. And we got the ancient scroll look around the borders of the each page with the modern look of the white page. Oh, man, with the Hebrew, the corresponding Hebrew on the left-hand side and the English on the right-hand side so that you can line up your text as you're reading. Say, for example, we're in chapter 23 and verse 23. We can read in Hebrew straight across that line like Brother Tyrone had mentioned, and then we can go across this way in English. And it's right down the center line of the column, so you can read one way and read the other way without with much less strain on the eyes, reading two languages and so forth, like so forth. So this has been like a great idea, and we've been working on it hard and diligently. And this is the best version of the Book of Jubilees that you can find anywhere. This is Hebrew and English with images of our people that you can't find in the sea, for you can't find in the Hallelujah scriptures, or you can't find anywhere else. And we got our own Paleo Hebrew text and font that we developed for this book. There's so much that went into this book, family. We can't even begin to tell y'all everything, all the bells and whistles for the Book of Jubilees. And we're going to read from this today, as well as the Book of Enoch, so that we can understand the calendar, the days and the times and the seasons. So this is the Book of Jubilees and the cover by Gadelia, my cousin. Hallelujah. Amen. Awesome cover. So we got the time. The time is almost at an end, family. We got the hourglass here because the sand crystals is running out. This is the time to get to know the Most High Yah and Yehoshua HaMashiach. This is the time to learn your language. This is the time to learn those law, statutes, and commandments. This is the time to turn away from Christmas. This is the time to stop eating pork. This is the time to turn away from the lies of Christianity. This is the time to get rid of white supremacist ideology. This is that time. Hallelujah. All praise to the Most High Yah.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Where can they find this awesome work, baby?
HebrewIsraeliteScriptures.com. Select shop. I'm about to put the link in the chat as well.
Should I show them? And this is the Enoch calendar, y'all.
Make it, no.
The 2024 Enoch calendar, man. And we're going to talk about the Maserot today, and we're going to show you the correlation between the House of Israel and the Maserot. Artwork by Jediah Yeshua. Hallelujah. Excellent pictures of the Maserot. We're going to talk about what this means for our people in these last days. There's a direct correlation here, family. We're going to get into it. Oh, read that for them, son.
Yehoshua HaMashiach.
Yehoshua HaMashiach. Hallelujah. So this starts off the calendar for the month of Aviv, which month we're in now. And we got powerful images that you cannot find. These are exclusive that we have created specifically for the house of Israel. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Exclusive, y'all. Hit like, hit thumb up, share this video, y'all. Mm. This book is historic. History, y'all.
Hallelujah.
The very last one. Oh man, Casita loves this picture here so much. This is the Maserot. This is, we have Yaakov, Jacob, with his four wives, and this represents the Enoch calendar. We're going to show you how Jacob and his wives are the Enoch calendar. We're going to show you this first here. And we gave a sneak peek to some of our Hebrew students already about some of this, but we're going to go all the way into it today. This is the Maserot. Jacob and his four wives and their 12 sons make up the Maserot, and their daughter Dinah make up the rainbow in heaven. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Man, hallelujah. We're going to get into this. All praise to the Most High Yah. Nasi and I was talking, and he shared this with me. So we were getting into this, man. Hallelujah. So we're going to show y'all the calendar really quickly, and then we're going to break it down for you. So we got the month of Aviv, which is the first month of the year for us as Israelites. And we have Yehoshua HaMashiach representing that. Read this to them, son. What's Hasofer mean?
Describe.
Enoch described. We got Chanuk. Hallelujah. Man, in his ancient garb in the wilderness, getting ready to go in the wilderness to rebuke the watches. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. And this represents judgment against the watches. Er, the bull. The bull who treads down the enemies of Yah. Hallelujah. The world calls it Taurus. Then we got Gemini or Siwan, which represents what?
Twins.
The twins, Jacob and Esau. Mm-hmm. All praise to the Most High Yah. Where have y'all seen this? This is the first of its kind. Oh, man, look at that. Family. Mm. Oh, man. I love this picture. This is for the twins, Gemini, Jacob, and versus Esau. This is what the twins are about, man. Man, we're getting into it. We're going to break all of this down. We're going to break it down. We're going to break it down. Look at the artwork, man. Y'all not going to find this anywhere else.
Nope.
Yeah, that's the real Game of Thrones right there.
Mm-hmm. Hallelujah. And after that, we got Tammuz, okay, which represents the crab. The world calls it cancer. We got, read that for them, family, son, to the family.
Kanu Kasofer with Sar Ha Ma'alakim, Ma'alakim Oreo.
Oreo, translate that.
So Enoch the scribe in Prince, the angel Oreo.
Yes, the prince or chief of the angels, or in English, the archangel Oreo. So we got Hanok going through the portals of heaven. This is the angel Oreo taking Enoch through the portals of heaven. And you can see the gateways behind them through which they're traveling to see everything as he was described, writing down our history, our past, and the presence. All praises to the Most High. Yeah, hallelujah. I love this picture here. Hallelujah. If you ever was reading the book of Enoch and you wondered, man, what did it look like when it was going through them portals? Man, what was it? This is it. This is it, family. Man. I'll show them a little more before we get into the study, or just get into the study. Y'all want some more?
You know they're going to say
yes. Yeah?
All right. Gotta get it.
Yeah, man. Y'all can find this at HebrewIsraeliteScriptures.com. There's so much more, family. There's so much more to this. Hallelujah. So let's say shalom to the family. And as you say shalom to them, I will be scrolling through. Okay, I'll just scroll through it. Or should I? Should I just hold off? Yeah, okay, I'm gonna hold off. I'm gonna scroll through what we already shown, and Cassita's gonna say shalom to everybody. Okay. That makes sense?
Okay.
All right, hallelujah.
All right, shalom to their Israel, Elder Zohar, Ima Eliana,
Jane,
Marcus and Nakia, Yahuwah's Kingdom. William Brookings, shalom, 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 Anyale, shalom to Claudine Jackson, shalom, Shar, shalom to the Hood family,
dang,
shalom to Marcia Hamilton, Ima Bithia, shalom to Josh Perez, shalom to Tori Jones, G Money, shalom, Sister Hadassia, shalom,
yes,
Sister Saraftia,
dang,
shalom, Brother Austin, shalom, Victoria Spirit, Tori Jones, to William Joseph, shalom to Eliezer and Alyosha.
Dang.
Shalom to Sister Jamila, shalom to Tony. Shalom MJ Moscato, shalom to Ahava Walters. Shalom Cynthia Lindsay, shalom Ima Samaya.
Dang.
Shalom Uziah Hill, shalom Marvelous. Shalom Brother Yeshaya Hu.
Dang.
Shalom Yeshan Benjamin. Shalom Ombre de Yawan. Shalom Raziel, shalom to the recruiter, shalom to Bray Howard, shalom to Brother Irene, shalom Yahusha, shalom to the recruiter, shalom, shalom Ya'akol 12 Yehuda, shalom to Jimmy, shalom to Israel's child, shalom to actual Israel, shalom to Lily, shalom, shalom to Michelle Richardson. Shalom to Unapologetically Real. Shalom, Yahoo. Shalom, Tashi P. Shalom, Lance White. Shalom, Dave Messenger. Shalom, Jason Camphor. Shalom to, I guess this is trademark, TM Cross Pulse. Shalom to Yakumiya, shalom to Cornell, shalom to Dwayne, shalom to Maria, Yashra All, shalom everybody, shalom to Sister Nicole Marie, shalom Brother Shadiq and family,
yes,
shalom to Kate Battle, shalom Monique Ann, shalom Sister Brandy, Sister Arcasia, shalom, shalom North Whitakers, shalom, Baruch Ekad 77. Shalom, Sister Doreen. Shalom to Soprano Jesse. Shalom to
shalom,
John P. Ben Yehuda. Shalom, everybody. Uh-oh, my thing just shifted. Hold on. To Dorian Britt. Shalom. To Brother Michael. Missed you in class today.
Dang.
Shalom, Patricia. Shalom, when the hallelujah stops. Shalom to Brother Kenya. Shalom to Tammy. Shalom to G. Ra'ala. Shalom to Arnell and Vanessa. Shalom, Sister Cheryl. Shalom to Ashakai. Let's see. Shalom, Pensy Lola. Y'all bless. And I missed anybody that came on a little earlier. We apologize, but it cuts off the names after a while. Shalom, JC. Shalom, Mighty Man of Valor. Shalom, Elijah, Isaiah. Shalom, peace and blessings. Shalom, Kava, Sarah. Shalom to Rachel. Shalom to Brother Nick. Shalom to Stan. And that's it.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. All right, family. So I got a question. Did you ever wonder when was the birthday of Judah, the patriarch, the head of the tribe of Yehuda? Well, if you ever wondered when their birthdays were, they're found in the book of Jubilees. Hmm. We went through the book of Jubilees and we recorded all of the birthdays of the patriarchs.
Hmm.
Okay, and we have listed them in the calendar. So on the month of Siwan, on the 15th day of that month is actually the birth of Judah, about 1 week after the Feast of Pentecost.
Ooh.
Look at that. Wow. The Feast of Pentecost, about a week later, birth of Yehuda. You can't make this up, man. And have you ever wondered when the priest, the birthday of Levi, the high priest, his birthday actually falls on the first day of the year, the month of Aviv, this fall? The birthday of Levi or Levi, the high priest. All praises to the Most High. So we have all of these days listed, man. And it's the first of its kind. You can't find this anywhere else. This is the only calendar that has all of this.
Mm-hmm.
All praises to Yah. So literally 2 weeks before the Passover is Levi's birthday. Look at that. Mm-hmm. So let's get into the scripture. We're going to read about the Enoch calendar by reading in the book of Jubilees. Should we start? Hey, Maury, should we go to Genesis first or should we go to Jubilees first? What do you think?
No, let's go to Jubilees. Let's start off with Jubilees. Yeah.
All right, we're going to go to the book of Jubilees, chapter 6. And we're going to start at verse 20. All right. The book of Jubilees. Get ready, y'all.
Mm-hmm.
Chapter 6, verse 20. You ready to read, Bainey? I'm going to pull it up big for you.
Mm-hmm.
Jubilees 6, 20. All right, I'm gonna do one more page down. This you can find on the website right now. If the Shabbat's down, if the sun went down in your area, you can go ahead. The sun is down for us over here. We're gonna read Jubilees 6 and 20. All right, this is verse 20 in Hebrew. You ready, Ben?
Okay.
Can you see? Do I need to do it bigger?
No, it's good.
Okay.
Uvyameka.
And in your days,
Sapu.
They have forgotten.
Bnei Yisrael.
The children of Yisrael have forgotten.
Ad Asher.
Until that which
Kidash Tiyua
was renewed unto them.
Bahar. Hazeh.
In this mountain. Until that which will be renewed unto them in this mountain. Go ahead.
Well, Atah, Zao,
when you command
Et Bnei Yisrael,
the children of Israel,
Roo,
and keep
Et Hachag,
keep the feast,
Hazeh,
this feast,
Bakal Dorotehem,
within all of your generations,
Le Mitzvah Lahem,
and command them.
Yom Echad.
On the first day.
Bashana.
Of the year.
Bakodesh.
Of this month.
Hazeh.
Mm-hmm.
Yaakov.
You shall keep the feast of it. Go ahead and read that out. We're going to go across to verse 20.
And you command the children of Israel, let them observe this festival in all their generations for a commandment unto them. One day of the year, in this month, they shall keep the feast.
Okay. Read more in English, and then when we get down to a certain place, we're going to read in Hebrew. Go ahead.
Verse 21. For it is Chag Shavuot and Chag Bikurim, the feast.
Chag Shavuot, that's the Feast of Tabernacles. So this is when the Feast of Tabernacles was given. Go ahead to the nation of Israel as a whole.
And Chag Bikurim.
And Chag Bikurim, which is the first fruits.
The Feast of the First Fruits. This feast is a double feast and a double ordinance, as it is written and engraved concerning it, shall you observe it.
Amen.
For I have written in the first book of Torah, in that which I have written for you, that you should keep it in its season, one day in the year. And I told you so that the children of Israel will remember its oblation and observe it throughout their generations in this month, one day in every year. And on the first day of the first month.
That's right after the spring equinox.
And on the first day of the fourth month.
That's right after the summer solstice.
And on the first day of the seventh month.
The fall equinox.
And on the first day of the 10th month.
The winter solstice. All of these right here represent time. We're going to come right back to this. I'm going to zoom in really quickly to this picture here of the cover. This represents the quarters of a clock. One, two, three, four. We got the spring equinox. Then we got the summer solstice. This is when Yah first gave us the revelation. And this is how it was understood. And all of the other calendars came from this. And all of the charts that you see online come from this original thing that we're showing you now. Ooh. All of them. Okay. So spring equinox, summer solstice. Go ahead. Fall equinox. And then the winter solstice, the four quarters of a clock. These are the four divisions of time, and it was given. So now we know where a clock and a watch come from, where the design of a clock comes from, that a watch that we wear on our arm or that we see on the wall to tell time is actually based off of the 12 tribes of Israel. We're going to show you that today. All praises to the Most High. Time itself is based off of the 12 tribes of Israel. We are the children of Israel, time and the clock. Esau owes us a patent for the clock. When we go get a Rolex or a Bulova or what's the other ones, the other watches, all of these watches, they owe us money because they stole it. We're going to show y'all, family. They owe us for this. So these four divisions, we're going to talk about what this is. And then we have a circle in the center. All right. This represents Yehoshua HaMashiach in the center. And then in the book of Revelation, we have the four beasts that surround the throne. Morey, could you get that scripture for us in Revelation with the four beasts? I think it's chapter 5, I think. And we're going to talk about the throne of the Messiah and the four beasts that surround his throne, because the center of this clock represents Yehoshua. He's the center of time, and then he has the four beasts that surround the throne. Once Morey grabs that, we're going to read that scripture.
Okay. Yeah. Revelation 5, chapter 6.
Revelations 5 and 6. I'm going to pull it up.
Yeah, Revelation chapter 5, verse 6.
Okay, give me one quick second. Let me pull that up on a different app. Where's another Bible app? Okay. Sleek. Okay. Revelation 5 and 6. Go ahead.
Revelation chapter 5, starting at verse number 6. And I beheld, and lo.
Let me take away. One second. Let me take away this. Let me just put all English here. Okay. Revelation 5 and 6. Go ahead.
And I beheld, and lo, in the midst of the throne and of the four beasts, and in the midst of the elders, stood a lamb as it had been slain, having seven horns and seven eyes, which are the seven spirits of Elohim sent forth into all the earth.
Hallelujah. What is 364 divided by 7?
52.
Let me screenshot. This is the Enoch calendar right here in your face. Let's. Well, huh? What happened? What I missed? Oh. Okay. Read some comments. In the meantime, I'll set this up.
All right. Let me see. Don't have any comments quite just yet.
Okay, that's fine. Yeah. Everybody's just learning.
They're learning right
Dang.
Now.
All right. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to write in red.
I have a comment. I want,
yeah, go ahead.
I want to say for the people with this new Book of Jubilees, one of the cool benefits of it is it has the precepts, but it doesn't just have the precepts, but it has the precepts highlighted, you know, per their location, Old Testament, New Testament, Apocrypha. Why this is a benefit is because you know, some of us, we've known about these books for some time, but this is an opportunity where you can share with others who are struggling to, you know, come out of paganism and, you know, the false ideologies, religions, and all those things out there. And then you have actual scriptures where you can show them that second and third witness in their own text. So.
King.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. So I'm going to put the throne. Y'all can write these things down for those who want to take notes. I would suggest it, trying to understand the calendar. The throne of Yahushua is the Enoch calendar.
I do get a nice comment.
Go ahead.
This is from Brother Lance. He says, wow, our Israelite ancestors created the concept of the clock way before Benjamin Banneker did.
Way before. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Benjamin Banneker, from what I understood, was an astute astronomer. Mm-hmm. So he was basing these things off of the heavens, which is where time comes from. The Enoch calendar and time itself comes from the signs in the heavens. All right. So the throne of Yehoshua is the Enoch calendar. So in the center, read verse 6 again.
Verse 6. And I beheld, and lo, in the midst of the throne and of the four beasts and in the midst of the elders.
So we have the midst of the throne. We have four beasts. We have elders and we have the lamb. Go ahead.
Stood a lamb as it had been slain, having seven horns and seven eyes.
Mm-hmm.
Having seven horns and seven eyes,
which
are the seven spirits of Elohim sent forth into all the earth.
And then it's sent forth into the earth. So now let's draw out what John is seeing. So in the midst of the throne, I'm going to make a circle here, right? Is what? Y'all remember? What was in the midst?
Four beasts.
But in the center, what was in the throne, or who was in the throne? Yeah, the throne of Elohim, what was in it? Where's what I'm looking for? I can't see what I'm looking for. And where is it at? My little gifs and stuff like that. Oh, here we go. Okay. So what we're going to do, we're going to get, let's see. Let's do GIF. Let's type in lamb. All right. So in the center, let's use that.
Was a slain lamb.
In the center is the lamb, right? So Yehoshua is the center of all things. And surrounding him were four beasts. So we had four beasts. We had... Can we find a sticker like that? Not necessarily. But let's just do it this way. We had, in the center, we had, around it, we had a lion. What else did we have? What were the four beasts? Shall I remember?
The eagle.
Dang. Lion. So we got a lion.
Eagle.
We got the eagle.
Man and the bull.
Excellent, Penny. We got the eagle here. We had a man. Esau by default puts himself when you put man, so. And the last one was a bull, right? Let's find a good picture of a bull. I don't got no good pictures, right? Let's do this one, the first one then. So you see, this is the throne of the Lamb. Read that one more time.
And I beheld, and lo, in the midst of the throne and of the four beasts, and in the midst of the elders, stood a lamb as it had been slain, having seven horns and seven eyes, which are the seven spirits of Elohim sent forth into all the earth.
All right, so we got the midst of the throne, right? We got the four beasts. Now we need the elders. How many elders were there? Hey, what happened? Okay, 24, right? So we got just like this, and it's going to look just like this, y'all. We got one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Oh, did I do too many? Yeah, sorry, I messed up. All right, we got four. Was it 9 and 12? I'm getting confused because the way we do the calendar is slightly different. They have, the way the world does it, they put 12 at the top, but it's really one at the top. So they start at 12, but in Hebrew thought it starts at 1. Okay.
So let's do it this way. 1, 2, 3, 4. Cain. 5, 6, 7. See how the seventh month is important? See how the first month is important? See that? The fourth month, the seventh month.
The seventh is holy, right?
Then we got 8, 9, and then the 10th month. And then we got 11 and 12. Oops. And 12. And it starts at 1. This is how we tell time, family. It's like this. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. But actually, in Hebrew thought, it goes from right to left. It goes what the world calls counterclockwise. That's the direction of time. Cain, like the clock up there, Cain.
Hallelujah.
And being that there's 24 elders, there should, you know, it's 24 hours in the day also. Yes. And as we look at the center of the picture, you see the lamb in the center, and that lamb was slain. So we know when Christ was in the tomb, a stone that was like in the form of this circle was rolled over the tomb. It had seven seals also on that stone that the Romans placed on there.
Deep.
And so those seven seals represent, you know, seven or 7 days in a week.
So, hallelujah.
Hallelujah. So we got 12 hours. That's excellent, brother. That's excellent. So we got 12, right? But we got 24 elders. So they represent the beginning times and the last times. They represent Genesis and Revelation. So in Genesis, who do we have? The 12 patriarchs. And in the Gospels, at the end, we got the 12 apostles. Okay, so that's what these represent around here. All right, so you're literally seeing time manifested right here in Revelation, but you wouldn't know that because did the rabbis teach anybody about this? But we're a cult, right? We're a cult. But the rabbis ain't teach y'all this. They ain't teach y'all this. This is time. Yehoshua's throne is the Enoch calendar. All right. So here we got what the world would call Leo. We got what the world would call Dan. We have what the world would call Reuben. And what the world would call this is Joseph. I put the wrong thing. I put Sliga. I'm a little ahead of myself. Let me do it this way. So Leo would be Judah. Dan would be Scorpio. Reuben is Aquarius. And Joseph is Taurus. Okay. So when you look at the tabernacle and the formations around the tabernacle of Moses in the wilderness, this is what you're seeing. So this is literally right here in the formation of Yehoshua's throne. So you have the 12 tribes surrounding the throne, and then you have the rainbow, which is Dina.
Wow.
Trying to put a little rainbow here. Right above there, that's Dina.
So something that interesting that you had said, we have the 12 patriarchs in the beginning, but then in the end, we have the 12 apostles. Yes. And I can see how that can correlate to time as well, where you have the 12 that represent the day. And then as it gets late, you know, in the time of Yehoshua's return is upon us, we have the second set of 12 for the last 12 hours where you have the apostles. So that's pretty cool how it all comes together.
Cain, the daylight represents, well, actually you could flip it both ways. The daylight represents, really, you could say Genesis or you could say Revelation. But it started, but the world started in darkness. So you could say the patriarchs, and then Yehoshua came to bring the light. Then you could say the apostles. Like day, every 24-hour period starts at night. Okay. So this is what we're dealing with. So in the beginning, there was darkness, and the earth was out form and dark, right? And then he said, let there be light. So first it was the patriarchs, and they didn't have the Messiah in the flesh. Then Messiah in the flesh comes, and he brings his 12 apostles. And this is the divisions of time. This is the equinox right there. The 12 patriarchs tell you the equinox, the division of 12 and 12, 12 daylight hours and 12 nighttime hours. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Can we get this from a lunar calendar? So you mean if we was to read Revelation, there's nowhere we can get a lunar calendar out of Yehoshua's throne? But what else are we missing? Seven, right? So how many days in a year the Enoch calendar? We're going to get to that. 364? Oops. 364 divided by 7 equals what?
52.
And what's 52?
7.
7.
Mm-hmm.
5 plus 2.
Mm-hmm.
See that? So it's perfect.
Mm-hmm.
So if we follow a lunar calendar, lunar calendars have 28 or 29 day cycles. Right. So, what's 29 times 12?
12? It's been a while.
Did I do that right? I need help.
I'll punch it in. See, 12 times 29 is 348. So you did it right.
348, right?
Yeah.
348, we good?
No, in 2 times 1, 2? Yeah.
So how much is it all together?
It should be 240. Yeah, there's 348, but you got 140. It should be 240.
Okay, 240. Okay. 348?
Yes.
All right. Yes, sir. So if we take a lunar calendar, let's give it 29 days, right? And we take 348. And we divide that by 7. What do we get? Divided by 7.
49.71.
49.71. Is that how many weeks in a year?
Nope.
See how the math is off?
Yeah.
Lunar calendar, if you take if they got 29 days in a year, and then you divide them 29 days in a year, you get 348 altogether for the year, and you divide that by 7, can you get 52 weeks?
Mm-mm.
Calendar's off.
Mm-hmm.
Even at its best, if you give it the longest amount of days in a month, 29, it's off. You can't even get 52 weeks, you'll get 49.7. So let's see what the Most High have to say about these things. Let's go to the book of Leviticus. Let's go to Leviticus 19.
Mm-hmm. This is Leviticus chapter 19, starting at verse 35. Ye shall do no unrighteousness in judgment, in meat work, in weight, or in measure. Just balances, just weights, a just ephah, and a just hin shall ye have. I am Yahweh, your Elohim, which brought
you. I am Yahweh, your Elohim. So Yahweh creates everything with just balances, just weights, a just ephah, a just hin. So how can you have a year, even if you say a year is 365 days, it still don't add up to 52 weeks with a lunar calendar.
Right.
Where did they learn that from? Let's read some comments.
Okay. I think that was the only one I had, but I read the Benjamin Banneker one. Let me see. Don P. Yehuda, he said, it is now day, but the night is coming when no man can work.
Yeah, that's why I said you can flip it. You can say it was light in the beginning and now the times are turning dark. So I see that angle too. You know what I'm saying? But that's why it goes in a circle. So if you look at the calendar, it's circular because the times rotate. In the beginning was what's in the end, as it was in the days of Noah, which is in Genesis, so shall it be in the days of the coming of the Son of Man, which is Revelation. So it's cyclical. Yeah. So it's a circle and that Maserot spins. That's why you can flip it that way. Okay, hallelujah.
She said their math is not adding up, and it never will.
It never will, huh? You don't look too happy about that. All right. So it won't add up, family. This is why. So we just read the verse, and look how we can read a verse in Revelation and see Enoch's calendar, and you can't extract anything about the lunar calendar from here. Right? Nothing at all. So we're going to go back to the book of Jubilees, right? We were in chapter 6.
Yeah.
Oh, we got to show them where they can get this, right? So y'all go to the HebrewIsraeliteScriptures.com website. When y'all go there, you hit on shop, because the shop bot has been over here for where those who you're at. You can get both of them here, the official Enoch calendar and the pre-order, the Book of Jubilees right here. And you, as you've been already seeing, we have outstanding and amazing imagery. We're going to show you how Jacob and his four wives and the house of Israel represent the calendar itself. All of this you can only find here. Okay, so this is where you go to get your Enoch calendar. So for all y'all where the sun is already down, y'all can go here right now and pick that up. This is the Enoch calendar. This is the original Enoch calendar. All praises to the Most High Yah. And we have the Book of Jubilees, the first of its kind in Hebrew and in English. And we have pictures. We're going to add some more pictures of the Hebrew text here and some of the photos that we have here, which are outstanding and amazing. We have precepts. We have quotes. We have images. We have everything in this. And Yah's name in Paleo Hebrew, y'all. All praise to the Most High in gold letters. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We worked so hard on this project, family. We worked so hard. If you know anything about translating the heathen, because I've seen some of these teams that they have for translating books, the heathen, when they translate these books, they have teams of about 60 to 70 people working on these things simultaneously. You know who it's been?
You're looking at him.
But through Yehoshua Mashiach, anything is possible. So he's taking us, this group right here in Gadelia, and put together a project that usually takes a team of about 60 or 70 people to do. And y'all, through the Rock High Kodesh, has allowed us to do this work, and we're here happy to share and present this to the nation of Israel in Paleo Hebrew, so that all the people, we all as Israelites, agree on Paleo Hebrew being the first form of Hebrew. So we decided to use that for the name of the Most High in this special edition. Hallelujah. Because all Israel agrees on these things. So we want to do things that help bring the people together. All right. So for all of the brothers and sisters, this is it. This is the this is it. And the pictures and the images are top notch. This is like top of the line, top of the line in color. While other books is always in black and white, ours is in color. All right. With the precepts, with all of these things. So we just want to share that with the people. So now let's get back into the scripture. So we want to show y'all where y'all can get these things. Let's go now to the book of Jubilees. We're going to go back to chapter 6. And we're going to pick back up and read.
Thomas Marshall just posted, wow, spring, summer, fall, winter. Four wives, 12 tribes, 12 months, and
the boys. There you go. That's it right there. Hallelujah. That's Jacob. That is it, family. Like, this is where you get it. Like, we are, as a people, our family, our set apart Hebrew family, we are the children of Israel. We are the Israelites. Okay. We come from Israel, from Jacob and his four wives. Jacob represents the sun, right? His four wives represents the four seasons. The 12 sons represent the 12 constellations. And we give light to the world. All praise to the Most High. Yeah. We give light to the world. So that is the revelation. Let me go to it. Let me go to it, since it was who brought that out? Because they're very perceptive. Hallelujah. Brother Thomas. Yes, that is the importance of this picture here. This is the last. Oh, I got to share the screen. I thought the screen was up already.
Okay, so beautiful.
Where is it at? Okay, here it comes. This is the importance. This is Casita's absolutely favorite picture. This is the last picture of the calendar. Again, this is all in the Enoch 2023-2024 calendar. The last picture is Jacob and his wives representing the sun and the four seasons. Leah, Zilpah, Bilhah, Raquel, and Bilhah. These are the four seasons. The spring and the fall, the summer and the winter. The solstices and the equinoxes represent the wives of Jacob, and they had 12 sons. And they had one daughter who was Dinah, the covenant, the glory of her father, Dinah. Okay. The sign, what does Dinah mean? The same as Dan.
No,
judge. Cain. And y'all put the bow in the sky to avoid, to keep from judgment, right? Okay. So this is what it is, family. So this is where you go to our website right now. You go to HebrewIsraeliteScriptures.com. You get the Enoch calendar. You'll see this picture, this one-of-a-kind, beautiful picture of Jacob and his four wives in their Hebrew garments and their Hebrew attire. All right. This is what it is, family. This is what the rabbis never wanted us to know. They wanted us to follow the moon. One of the problems with following the lunar calendar is if it's storming outside. Let's say we're in the winter. Let's say we're in the fall and it's raining. And you have to go outside to see if the moon is a sliver. Or you got to see if it's completely dark. Or however, there's different people who have different ideologies on when the month starts when using the moon. If it's snowing outside, or if it's storming outside, and if it's cloudy, how can you tell if your new year started? How can you tell if your seasons change? How do you know? If you have to go out every day to observe the moon in order to know when time has moved forward, and it's, let's say it's cloudy outside and stormy for a whole week. How are you going to keep the feast? So let's go. This is our heritage. This is who we are. This is what I mean when I say we are the calendar. The children of Israel, the black and Hispanic man and Native American, we are the children of Israel. We are the calendar. Time revolves around us here on this earth. We are the light of the world. All praise to the Most High, y'all.
Hallelujah.
And the time of the Gentiles is running out. The time of the Gentiles is running out. The time of the Gentiles is at an end. It's our time again. In the beginning and in the end is our time. And in the middle was their time.
Amen.
Now we're in the end times. It's our time again. Hallelujah. Let's go back now to Jubilee. Let's pick up at chapter 6. Okay. This is in the new book of Jubilees, the Paleo Hebrew edition. Go ahead, Ak.
Starting at verse 25. Verse 28 is where we left off, I believe.
Oh, right? Actually, we were in 28.
Oh no, right there where you actually highlighted. That's correct. Okay. That's why I was looking at those the equinoxes, and I thought, okay, we had jumped down, but so
okay, so as we were reading this, that's why we noted these things within the text itself in parentheses. So that when people are reading these, they actually know what's being talked about. Because if this is not there in the book, you might not understand what Moses is even saying. So you can't find this in any other edition of the Jubilees, Book of Jubilees, except here. Go ahead.
Verse 24. And Noach ordained them for himself as feasts throughout the generations forever, for they were a memorial unto him. And beside this, it was commanded him in the first month to make an ark. And on that day, the earth became dry. And he opened and saw the earth. Verse 26. And on the first day of the fourth month, summer solstice, the mouths seventh month. The
mouths of the depths.
Oh, yeah, it was cut off. Okay. The mouths of the depths of the abyss beneath were closed. And on the first day of the seventh month, fall equinox, all the mouths of the abysses of the earth were open, and the waters began to descend into the abyss beneath. And on the first day of the 10th month, the winter solstice, the tops of the mountains were seen, and Noah rejoiced. And on this manner, he ordained them for himself as feasts for a memorial forever. And thus are they ordained.
So you can see all of these dates about the equinoxes in the book of Enoch, chapter 72, verse 13, 14, 19, and 20, or Enoch 72, verses 25 to 26. That's what all of these precepts represent. So you can see the actual precepts. Should we go and show them? All right, let's go to the book of Enoch, the book and secrets of Enoch, another book that Yah blessed us to publish, Enoch 72. And let's do 13. So let's go to Book of Enoch. Man, here we go. Oh, that's the calendar. There's so many here. Did I pass it up?
Yeah.
Okay, here we go. Toda. The Book of Enoch, chapter 72. Here we go. So we have it here shown and demonstrated here. All right. The 364 dated divided into four seasons. All right. So we have it mentioned here too, the solstice. We have the second month, the third month, the summer solstice in verse 14. Verse 15, we have the fifth month. The summer solstice here. The sixth month is being mentioned here. The seventh month is being rested here. The autumn equinox. And on that day will be equal with the night. And on that day, the day will be equal with the night and becomes of equal length. That's the autumn equinox. And the night amounts to nine parts and the day to nine parts.
And that we can find in Jubilees 6 and 23. Okay, and the days are 30 days in a month, all the way till we get back around to the winter solstice, the ninth month, 10th month, winter solstice, 11th month, and then the 12th month all over again. And then we're back at 364. On that day, the night decreases and it shall become, and it shall be nine parts and the day to nine parts. And the night is equal to the day, which is a vernal equinox. And the year is exactly as to its days 364. So that's what we have here. We got the precepts in the Book of Enoch, which is also on the Hebrew Israelite Scriptures website. So we're showing you all of these things with Hebrew and English. For those who don't know if these are authentic books, that's why we put the Hebrew with it as well.
Mm. Also, as a side note, for that winter solstice, right? The last day of the Feast of Dedication is the first day of winter, or somewhere thereabout. It's pretty close. It's like either the same day or the next day.
Absolutely. So go ahead, Ark.
Verse 29. And they are mentioned on the heavenly tablets. Each had 13 weeks.
So these are mentioned. These are written on heavenly tablets. Let me show you this. These are written on heavenly tablets. And so this is what we have here on the cover. We have Kanok holding the heavenly tablets in his hand. Okay. So Enoch received these same things. Moses received them as well. So Kanok had the heavenly tablets in his hand.
Verse 29, and they are mentioned on the heavenly tablets. Each had 13 weeks from one to another as a memorial, from the first to the second, and from the second unto the third, and from the third unto the fourth.
So what is that saying here? And they are mentioned on the heavenly tablets. Each had 13 weeks from one to another as a memorial, from the first to the second, and from the second unto the third, and from the third unto the fourth.
Yeah, that's the division.
Right.
Between the solstices. Yeah.
So each of these four seasons has 13 weeks. What does that 13 represent? 13 apostles. The 13 apostles. I like that answer. You're right in one sense. That's the lesser answer, but there's another answer, and then that answer is right beneath it. That's the second answer. The first answer is Yehoshua and his 12 apostles. That's why 13 is an unlucky number for the world. The world say 13 is bad luck. That's Yehoshua and the 12 tribes of Israel. That's Yehoshua and the 12 apostles. That's superstitious to the world.
And I believe it's also that 13 in the world sometimes represents change. And it's really strange that it represents that, because now, you know, as an older person versus when I was a child, I can say, okay, if 13 represents change, it's actually the 13 weeks, then you change to a new season. So it was kind of like it was out there in front of us the whole time.
Okay. You know? And then eventually, as Yehoshua inherited the throne of the Father, as we read later in Revelation, right? He said he sits on the throne of his Father. As he goes to sit on his throne, on the Father's throne, then he sends Paulos to take his place, the 13th apostle.
Hallelujah.
All right, so you have the 13 apostles. That's Paul with the 12. So that was the first answer you said. That's the 12 with Paul, but before it is Yehoshua with the 12, but then Yehoshua ascends even higher. And Paul is in their midst. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Chapter 6, verse 30.
And all the days of the commandment shall be 52 weeks of days, and these shall make the whole year complete.
Go ahead, son, thus, read that. I'm gonna point to it right here. Starting there.
Why he Cal Yame.
You gotta speak loud.
Why he Cal Yame. Mitzvot.
And it came to pass that all these days that the commandment
Hamishin Ushtim
50 and 2.
Shavtot.
What's Shavtot? Shabbat. 52 Sabbaths. 52 weeks.
Yamin
of days. Mm-hmm. And these shall complete the years.
Tamima.
And they are perfect. Hallelujah. Let's read the next one in English. Verse 31, complete or perfect? Go ahead.
Verse 31. Thus it is engraved and ordained on the heavenly tablets, and there is no transgressing this commandment for a single year. From year to year.
There is no transgressing this commandment. So we can't ever have a year that has 365, or how many days was the lunar one? 349? We can't transgress this commandment. We can't believe what nobody else says. Because the scriptures, and we're showing you in Hebrew, we're showing you in Hebrew, and we're showing you in English to make it plain. We're showing you. This is written by the hand of Moses and by the hand of Enoch, the first two scribes, right?
Yeah.
You want to read that, Bainey?
Yeah. Kaka de Kerat.
Mm-hmm. Wahukwam came.
Bilukot.
You gotta read loud, son.
Bilukot.
On the tablets.
Hashemayim.
Mm-hmm, of heaven.
Velo Yaavor.
And they shall not transgress or not pass away.
Shana Ahat.
From 1 year.
Mishana.
Or from year to year. It shall never pass away. Hallelujah. This commandment is to be a perpetual commandment. 364 years, 52 weeks, 13 seasons. Make sense? Hallelujah. Four divisions, like the four wives of Jacob.
One of the funny things I like to do when trying to explain this to people who are still in the Christian church, you know, you ask them, you say, okay, there's 52 weeks in a year. They'll get that part. But if you try to ask them what week has the extra day, and you just, it's kind of funny because you see it, like the wheels start turning in their head, and they're trying to figure it out. I'm like, okay, well, if it's 7 days in a week, which week mm-hmm. has the extra day in it to make this right. 365? And they can't right. do it. You know, it's just, you know, kind of funny.
Sense. You can't add up, right? Just like Christianity, 3 days and three nights, and he rises on a Sunday. From Friday, he's killed on Good Friday. 3 days and three nights is Sunday. Mm-hmm. Sunday morning, right? Make it make sense.
Mm-hmm. Verse 32. And command you the children of Israel that they observe the years according to this number, 364 days, and a year shall be complete. And they shall not corrupt its appointed seasons from its days and from its feasts, for everything shall abide in them according to their testimony, and they shall not be undone, nor shall they corrupt any feast.
Precepts, Enoch 72, mm-hmm. Enoch 74, Enoch mm-hmm. 82. Look mm-hmm. at all those precepts there, family. Let's read that in Hebrew, verse 32.
Mm-hmm.
And you?
Zao.
Command?
It.
Mm-hmm.
B'nai Israel.
The children of Israel. That they shall keep.
Et ha-shanim.
The years.
Ha-mispar.
According to the number.
Hazeh.
This number.
Shalosh.
300.
Washishim.
And 60.
And
4.
Yamin.
Days.
Yihyu.
There shall be.
Shana.
And the year.
Tamimim.
Shall be perfect or complete.
Velo yash. Scroll. Velo yash kitu.
And no shall it be destroyed, I think.
Et moada.
The moadim, or the appointed seasons.
Miameha.
From its days. Or from its feast,
ki hako,
for everything
yabo,
shall come
aleihem,
unto it
lefi,
according to
adutam,
their witness or their testimony.
Walo ya'avdu,
and you shall not destroy these things, or these things shall not perish.
Walo yashkitu,
nor shall they be destroyed of their feasts. Amen. Nor shall they be corrupt. Okay. Hallelujah. Destroyed or corrupted. Hallelujah. Go ahead, Ak. Verse 33.
And if they alter and do not observe them according to his commandment, then they shall corrupt all their seasons, and the years shall depart from this order, and their seasons and their years will transgress their set time.
So if you change or shift even one day from this divine and holy order of the Enoch calendar, all of time starts to get distorted. So if you change one day, then all the feasts shift. And the days become dislodged and people become confused. And then with the confusion, that's why we see in Israel, we see a multitude of different calendars and this and that, because people have dislodged days. And so we have all kinds of calendars popping up every day in Israel. And that's because things have been dislodged. Okay, go ahead. Oh, let's read that. Did we read that in Hebrew?
Wait, verse 32?
Yeah, he just read 33, right?
Yeah. Yes.
Well, let's read 33 in Hebrew. And if these things pass away or transgress, and you don't keep them or do them according to their commandment concerning them, all of these shall be corrupted. All of their times. And they shall go. The year shall go from it. And the times. And the years. Shall pass away. They shall transgress the decree or the ordinances or the statutes of the Most High. All right. Told me old. Okay, Ak, you're going to read 34, Torah?
Yes, sir. Verse 34. And all the children of Israel shall forget and shall not find the path of the years, and shall forget the renewed months and the Shabbat and the feast. And the set times of the years shall go astray.
Mm-hmm. Go ahead.
Verse 35, for I know, and from henceforth, behold, I shall declare it unto you. And it is not from my own heart, for the book is written before me. And the division of days is ordained on the heavenly tablets, lest they forget my feasts and my covenant and walk according to the feast of the nations.
They walk according to the feast of the nations. I'm not sure who Moses was talking about just yet, but there's certain nations
that the children of Israel would start mimicking and following behind their doctrines. And these things would begin to confuse the people, okay? We would start to take on their ways and their thoughts and see things the way they see them. And speak the way they speak. So these things would happen, and Moses warned us about it, but I'm not exactly sure. I'm still trying to do research on who he's talking about. Maybe it'll be revealed at some point soon. Maybe somebody will prophesy it. I don't know. Maybe vocab will prophesy the answer. Who are these people that Moses was talking about? I don't know. I was cracking up.
I'm telling you, man.
Go ahead, Albany. Verse 34. And they shall forget. All the children of Israel shall forget. And they shall not find the way of the years, the path of the years. And they shall forget Kodesh, the months.
With Shabbat.
And the Shabbat, they're going to forget. You got some people keeping Shabbat on Wednesday afternoon or Tuesday morning.
It's true.
If you notice, how many of those people who do these things really understand the language? How many of them can break down and read the language? They don't have a Hebraic understanding. Some people keeping it Monday. You know what I'm saying? This is why our people have to learn our language, because then our doctrine will become one. And it's not to throw shots at anybody. We're just saying that the elders of our people have to become literate in our language. If you are an elder, you should know how to read, right? Okay. Go ahead.
Kabbalah Israel.
You got to read something with more force. Israel. No, down here, son.
Wakab.
And feasts.
Wakolkab.
Wakolkok. And all of the statutes. We're going to forget all of the feasts and all of the statutes.
Ashadim.
And the years.
Yatsu.
I think shall be removed or displaced or something. Very good.
Hold up, Brother Derek Israel, for your super chat.
Hallelujah. I appreciate that.
Verse 35. For I know, and from henceforth, behold, I shall declare it unto you, and it is not from my own heart, for the book is written before me, and the division of days is ordained on the heavenly tablets, lest they forget my feast and my covenant, and walk according to the feast of the nations after their error and after their foolishness.
After their error and after their foolishness. Mm. Moses was really going in. He was really going in hard on them, man. He said after their error and their foolishness. I don't know why he would say that, but what we're going to do is we're going to take a short break and try to meditate on the words of Moses and why he would call it foolishness. You know, y'all got any idea why he would speak so harshly about some of these people and their foolishness? I'm not sure. Let's see.
Little kid.
Yeah, Moses definitely wasn't talking about them. These are the children of Israel. But yeah, let's read one. Let's see that. Let's see the words of Moses one more time, man. Let's see what he said. Read that verse again, verse 35.
Middle of verse 35. On the heavenly tablets, lest they forget my feast and my covenant and walk according to the feast of the nations after the error and after their foolishness.
After their error and after their foolishness. What was he talking about? These are the things we have to try. Who's tried to warn us about, and we just have to continue to pray for discernment on what it was Moses was trying to let us know. I don't know. So yeah, man. Go ahead. You can finish that.
Verse 36, and they shall be those who regard the moon and how it corrupts the seasons and comes in from year to year, 10 days too soon.
Man, so some of them look at the sun, moon, and stars. And I guess he's saying they worship the devil. You know, that's kind of what he's saying. They look up at the stars of heaven and they worship. The devil, while trying to use the scriptures, you know what I'm saying, to discern the times. So these are the things we got to pray for discernment on.
Yeah,
but it's not them. Go ahead. These people are holy. Yeah, they are Quadesh.
Therefore,
Quadeshim.
Oh, God.
Oh, man.
Your brother Shadiq said, I never knew how fickle those people were until Moray started his
theater. I'm telling you.
Man, you know, they dance in circles like the Enoch calendar. That's how you know it's just in their DNA, because when they dance in the formation of the Enoch calendar. And a lot of people wouldn't even know that. Break that scene down. See, they hold hands and they dance in a circle just like the Maserati, right? And the man whose hat was on fire, he was spinning in circles, just like time goes in a circle. But Tyrone, you was breaking it down that scene before and how black people stole music from them and stole dances from them. So explain. Hold on, let me change the screen real quick. I want you to explain how black people stole their musical gifts. You know,
so as we can clearly see, for example, a lot of our phraseology that we use today, right? We're going to take the term lit, for example. Now we clearly see that the gentleman, he lit his hat on fire and he went in, he cleared the dance floor, right? This is what you used to see back in the day, like back in the '90s with the B-boy dancing, somebody getting hyped in the circle, and then a circle starts backing away from them, letting them take the floor. So this is where you get the term.
That's where that came from. You know, black and Hispanic people, they stole that. Go ahead.
Clearly. That's why you see how he's doing all this. He's doing all this while his hat is lit on fire. All right. Now you can clearly see the gentleman, hopping around, getting sturdy, I'm just saying, this is where your latest dance crazes are coming from. All right. So we have to, like they say, we have to spirit in the truth, right? it is clear that, we have plagiarized these dance moves and phraseology,
Absolutely. You got to give credit to where it's due. And Moses was trying to warn us about a certain people that would actually begin to steal. Go ahead.
Mm-hmm. And there's one last thing, right? Now, obviously I'm old. So back in my day, there was a phrase, they used to say, the roof is on fire and raise the roof.
Right.
Now, when you replay the gentleman with the hat on fire, his hat was on fire and he went in. And he start doing a little jig like this, raising his hands. That's where you get raising the roof, and the roof is on fire.
Right, man. And this is where stepping comes from,
Exactly.
All of this stuff, man, all of this, So we just have to edify, and talk about the tribe of praise and where all black dancers come from to begin with. This is where it comes from. And, we have to tell the truth. All right, let's get back to these scriptures. Oh, you had some more breakdown, huh?
Nah, he lit, man.
Yeah, he's lit. Where do you think they get this from? Mm-hmm. The party's lit, mm-hmm. Scene is lit, all of that stuff,
Verse 37.
Mm-hmm.
Therefore, the years shall come upon them when they shall corrupt and make a contemptuous day the day of testimony, and an unclean day a feast day. Mm. And they shall confound all the days, the Kodesh with the unclean, and the unclean day with the Kodesh, for they shall utterly corrupt the moons and Shabbats, or Shabbats, and feast of the Yobelim.
Right. So you would have a group of people who they're going to change all of it, and their leaders would stand in the midst and teach these things to people who think that all.
Oh, man.
So brother Yadiah is gonna Mora Yadiah is taking a break right now. Mm-hmm. He's coming to grips with realizing that his whole B-boy career from New York was a fraud because it was stolen. It was stolen from these highly talented individuals. So he's had to, you know, turn the camera off. The cover says shame, right? All those circles he lit up. You know what I'm saying? You know how we used to walk around with the cardboard, throw it down on the concrete, start, you know, spinning and everything? Now he's realizing where it all originates from. You know what I'm saying? Whatever we can, you know, like they say, the truth sets you free, man. It's all right, man. Acceptance is the first step, right?
Man. Yes, yes. You know, I had to repent, you know. Got some comments.
Oh God. Yeah, I did want to add one comment on verse 37. When we look at all the different calendars around Israel, right? Because of all these different calendars and people following the moon and all these things, a lot of times their feast days will fall on unclean days. Mm-hmm. Now, I think this is really powerful and really spiritual in a sense, because there are actually heathenistic days that a lot of people will celebrate their feast days on. But these days are also there as an indicator to us who are awake to say, hey, I might be celebrating on the wrong day.
Right.
Right. If I'm celebrating, for example, Passover on, on Easter in the middle of April, because their calendar jumps like 23 days at some points.
Right.
That's a clue. If I'm celebrating unleavened bread during the time of, what do they call that? St. Patrick's Day. These are clues. These are unclean days, and they're labeled in the scriptures. This was prophesied ahead of time. There's a lot of days like this, right? You have people who will celebrate their Purim on the same time as Valentine's Day, you know, things like this. And that's tied to Tammuz, you know, the whole Cupid situation. Right. So that verse 37 is a lot to unpack in there for people who may not have seen this before. And I recommend people really get this, because I know the More Obed Yahu, he's on TikTok. Right. And he's teaching the people. And I noticed using Book of Enoch, Brother Yediah, it was able to reach people, because when you show it to them on screen, they can see the precepts, right? Yeah. And I know we keep skipping over it, but it's very important how these precepts are in there. And so I really commend you for that, because that's a really powerful tool, and it really helps you see some people. They may not come out and say it, but they start thinking, like, wait a minute, okay, now I can see where this goes, and this goes to this scripture with what they're familiar with. It opens their understanding, and it allows them to study a little bit further.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Can I just add something?
Please. Yeah.
Verse 34. And all the children of Israel shall forget and shall not find the path of the years and shall forget. Now, we're just going to pause there. This is why it's important. We have the Hebrew version. All the other versions out there, it doesn't say renewed months. You can look at renewed months. It will say they shall forget the new moons. That's what it is in all the other versions. So when you read verse 34 in New Moons and compare it to verse 36, you see an immediate contradiction, which they're not understanding. Because then it says, so if we read verse 34 with New Moons instead of renewed months, then verse 36 says, and they shall be those who regard the moon and how it corrupts the seasons. So it makes a direct contradiction. Now we've got the Hebrew side by side. You can see it doesn't say New Moons. It says renewed months.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Kane, excellent, excellent point. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Kane, Toda. Go ahead, Ak.
Verse 38. Therefore, I command you and testify to you that you may testify to them, for after your death, your children shall corrupt them, so that they shall not make the year 364 days only. And therefore, they shall disturb the new year and Shabbat and seasons and feasts, and they shall eat all kinds of blood with all kinds of flesh.
Okay. So these things were prophesied to happen Thank you, Brother Joe, for the support. Appreciate that.
Hallelujah.
I have
to start paying my tithes and offering for that historical B-boy performance. We got a little video that we're going to play. I want you to read the copyright, please.
Yes.
Let me pull that up. Hold on 1 second. Okay.
Warning. Federal law allows citizens to reproduce, distribute, or exhibit portions of copyrighted motion pictures, videotapes, or video discs under certain circumstances without authorization of the copyright holder. This infringement of copyright is called fair use and is allowed for purposes of criticism, news reporting, teaching, and parody.
We have to read this because this guy flags videos for anything that doesn't go along with what he teaches. So we just got to be safe on this one. I can't risk it.
Wow, who is this?
I'm going to play this video.
It looks like your video, brother.
Yeah.
Then your father, who sees what is done in secret, will reward you. And when you pray, do not keep on babbling like pagans, for they think they will be heard because of their many words. Do not be like them, for your father knows what you need before you ask him. This, then, is how you should pray. Our Father in heaven, be your name. Your will be done. Forgive us our debts, as we also have forgiven our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. For if you forgive others when they sin against you, your heavenly Father will also forgive you. But if you do not forgive others their sins, your Father will not forgive your sins.
Man, look at that intro. That's actually when I took time to make good videos, you know? This is the original Enoch calendar video from 2012. This is from which all the other calendars derive, okay? So we're going to show you the breakdown of the calendar from the book of Genesis, from all the a lot of Old Testament scriptures and New Testament scriptures. So this was the original calendar. Before this, there was no Enoch calendar. You couldn't go on Google and find any Enoch calendar, and everything else afterwards would derive from this. So we want to show you the foundation and how Yah has brought it 10 years in, hallelujah, to the special edition calendar that we have today. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Dang.
Shalom, brothers and sisters, and all the saints of the Most High God, to the 12 tribes of the children of Israel.
Man, it looked like my son. Looks like my son, man.
Look at this fresh guy, man.
Okay, this is the original video, right? You remember that guy?
Yeah.
And all those who are
old Blackbeard there, you know.
All by the name of Jehovah, I greet you, shalom. This is your brother Jediah, and I'm happy to be here, and I thank the Most High for an opportunity to share the word again with you. I want to say thank you to all the brothers and sisters who've been sending me messages to see if I have been okay. I've been quite well and quite busy, as you'll see.
I was doing videos at the time, and I took a long break because I was praying in the Most High, give us understanding concerning this calendar. And so I was doing videos at that time, but I had to take some time in the secret place. And so that's why I started saying that at the time.
A lot of work for the Most High God. Still teaching the word and trying to gather the house of Israel together.
Brother Scott, man, we appreciate you, brother. Y'all bless you. And Toda for the support. Good to see you, brother.
You on one accord. Today's lesson, we're going to talk about the calendar of Enoch and the signs of the times. This is a very, very important message that it is my true and heart's desire that it will help to bring the children of Israel together on one accord, so that we'll be on one calendar, totally supported by scripture through and through, that's been tested, that the Most High has revealed to me, and that I have shared with my brother Kasada Ba, even my brother Lamad Yahu, and Emmanuel. Because as it is written, out of the mouth of two or three witnesses shall every matter be established. And so before presenting this information, I've shared it with several brothers that are very knowledgeable in the word, so that they can test it to see if this count and this calendar is accurate, and if it lines up with Yehoshua's ministry and both the old covenant and the new covenant. So
back in those days when I did video, I have a scripture at the bottom of the screen every 8 seconds, literally. I wanted the videos to be filled with scripture and never wanted to turn away and lean on my own understanding. So you'll see scripture continually at the bottom of the screen. That's how I would do back in those days. Right? But since we published the book, I kind of eased up a little bit on that.
Before we get into this, I would like to say to Fila Yehoah, Avinu, Sheba Shemayim, Yikudah Shem Ka, Tabo Malkute Ka, Yahase Razon Ka, Ka Sheba Shemayim, Damba Audits, Tain Lanu Lakanku Kwenu Hayom, Salakanu Kola Shantainu, Kaishir Salakim Otano Ashmulanu, Wa Al Tavienu Lede Nasion, Ki Tikazenu, Minhara, Kilaka Hamamuka, Wahagabora, Wahatapetit, Le Ola Me Ola Me, by Shem Yehoshua Hamashiach. Hallelujah, Amen. So, as we get into this lesson, I'm going to start with three Hebrew vocabulary words that fit with the theme of this teaching. The first one is Yareach. Yareach means moon. Okay, Yareach means moon, and it is a word that is used within scripture several times, but there's another word that's commonly used in EV that's mistaken for the word moon, and that word is Chodesh. Chodesh means new or month, or even new month. Now, the problem that we have within scripture as it pertains to the calendar and what is commonly known as the new moon in English translations of the Hebrew text, this word Kodesh is commonly used, but it's translated as new moon. But the term new moon never appears in the Hebrew Bible whatsoever. Okay, so there's a mistranslation for this word. If the phrase new moon were to appear in Hebrew, in the Hebrew text, it would be Yareach Kodesh. Okay, but that phrase never appears anywhere within scripture. And again, the word for moon is Yareach, not Kodesh. Kodesh is new or new month or month. So when we see this phrase Kodesh, it's been mistranslated, thereby creating a lot of confusion within Israel about when the months and the new years begin. So by studying and developing this Enoch calendar and going through the count again, we're going to be on one accord after this lesson. And the third word that we have here is Sha'a. Sha'a means hour, all right? Sha'a means hour. Now, to say, to ask the question in Hebrew, what time is it? The phrase is Mahasha'a, which means what is the hour? But translated to English, we say, what time is it? But in Hebrew, they say, what is the hour? Now, the very interesting thing about the Most High's creation in the heavens, the sun, moon, and stars, is that that is the heavenly timepiece, the heavenly clock by which all scripture surrounded by, all of our.
So we just showed y'all earlier how it's a heavenly clock, right? We want to say Toda to Sister Cheryl for the $20 super sticker. We appreciate you, Akoti. Toda. So now we just showed you even more definition of how it's a heavenly clock. And we read it straight from Revelation, right? I didn't plan that. I just said, let's go to Revelation and see what it says. And we drew the calendar out of that. See, so when you read Revelation, Revelation is supposed to give us understanding of everything that is right now. So we can't get any understanding out of a lunar calendar reading this book. None. None in Revelation, okay?
Holy days, all about festivals, feast days, fasts. It all revolves around Yahweh's timepiece, which is the sun, moon, and stars. And just to clarify that he created the sun, moon, and stars as our time, as our clock, or to determine the seasons and the years, let's get that scripture in the book of Genesis, the first chapter. Okay, we're going to go to Genesis 1. I believe it's the 14th verse. Let me turn to it.
That light was really hot on me, so it was like a lot of sweating. See those lights reflecting? Thing was hot.
Boy. Okay, we're going to go to Cain. Genesis 1 and 14. It reads, "And Elohim said, let there be lights in the firmament of the heaven to divide the day from the night, and let them be for signs and for seasons and for days and years." So there is confusion within Israel, where we have people who are looking at the growth of barley or any kinds of crops within the spring season to determine when the year starts. And that's against scripture, because from the very beginning, we see that the Most High God, Yahweh, created the sun, the lights in the firmament as a timepiece to determine the years, the months, the weeks, the days, and so forth, the times and the seasons. So we need to know Enoch's calendar and the sign of the times. I'm going to read one more verse, a few more verses. And 16. "And Elohim made two great lights, the greater light to rule the day and the lesser light to rule the night. He made the stars also. And Elohim set them in the firmament of the heaven to give light upon the earth and to rule over the day and over the night and to divide the light from the darkness. And Elohim saw that it was good, and it was in the evening and the morning were the fourth day." So we see that on the fourth day of the week, the Most High God created the sun, moon, and stars. However, the week of creation had already began. The creation week began on what we commonly call Sunday, or in Hebrew would be the first day. So on Sunday, he created, let's fill this in actually now. On the first day of the week, the Most High God created he created light and separated it from the darkness. So I put light and dark. On the second day, the Most High God created the firmament. So I'm going to put firm for firmament. On the third day, the Most High God created the land, and he created seeds and fruit and trees to grow. So I'm going to put land, trees. But it was not until Wednesday, what is commonly known as hump day, or in Hebrew, the midst of the week, that he created the sun, moon, and the stars. So I'm going to put a picture of the sun here and the moon right next to it. This is when our calendar count should actually start. Oh, well, actually, before I get ahead of myself, he created the sun and moon.
So the equinox is on Wednesday. Okay, that's where it's equal periods of daylight and equal periods of night. 12 and 12 representing the 12 patriarchs and the 12 apostles in 24-hour period. Okay? And during the center of the times.
It starts during the midst of the week, which is a Wednesday. And the first day that the Most High God actually created life on the earth, was on the fifth day of the week. So he created life on the earth on the 6 days by creating the fowl of the heavens and the fish of the seas and so forth.
So that's the first day that life is represented. After the sun, moon, and star was created, then you see living beings and living creatures. See? So this is the beginning of the new phase of life. So where people go off, where they've changed the Enoch calendar, some people will start things from Sunday, because Sunday is the beginning of the week instead of the midst of the week, and that's where they go wrong. And shifting that will throw off your whole calendar. Okay.
So the midst of the week is the sun and the moon created, and then right after that is when we see life appear on the earth. So this is a very key point that is going to tie into the lesson. All right, now to get into it. Like I said before, if we look at the sun, moon, and stars as a clock or a timepiece that Yahuwah created in order for us to keep track of the years, times, and seasons, we can really fully understand the depths of the times in which we live in. On any clock, we have three major components. We have one, the hour. On Hebrew, sha'ah. Minute is dakot, and seconds, I forget the word for second, but I'll find out for you. But hour, sha'ah, minute, dakot, and then seconds. We have three major hands on every clock, all right, on every clock or timepiece. But only one of these three hands is the foundational piece through which all the two other hands rely on, all right? And that hand, the hand that determines time the most and the others complement this hand, is the hour hand. All right, so we have three hands. I'm going to use black to determine, to describe, to present the hour hand. So we have the hour hand in black. Oh, this black is not too good. So I'm going to use,
I mean, thank y'all. We could do it on the iPad now, you know, instead of the marker. Yeah. Boy. The markers would dry out, boy.
Yeah.
Old school, man.
This is our hour hand. And right now I'm going to have the hour hand pointing at 12. I'm going to use blue for the minute hand. And then we have green for the second hand. These are the three major components of every clock. By this, we're able to determine the time. Now, the heavenly fixtures that the Most High has created.
Can you put the link in the video in the chat for this video? Somebody asked me.
Instead of, and like I mentioned before, the hour is the foundational hand by which the other two hands complement this. And the sun, moon, and stars works much in the same way. The main piece of telling time is the hour, but the main way in which we tell the year is by the months. So if we look at this clock as a representation of the sun, moon, and stars, then the hour hand would be representative of each month. Just like if you look at a clock, and I firmly believe, because the Holy Spirit has been revealing this to me. I've been working on this for months, along with my brother Kasada Bach. He's been working on this diligently, and I hadn't put out any video until I had this subject totally down, because it's very important for all Israel to come together by this lesson.
And it's amazing how 10 years later, how the calendar has spread everywhere. Even though some people have shifted days and such, the calendar now has gone worldwide. Even the Gentiles use the Enoch calendar now. So we just thank Yah that, you know, you never know if you follow the talents that the Most High give you. You never know what y'all can take it and do with it. At this time, I didn't want to teach this because I had a tooth just fall out my mouth in the front. And I was like, man, I didn't even have time to get it fixed yet. And I didn't want to do the video yet. And the Most High was like, do the video. So sometimes to be worthy to receive revelations, you got to be worthy to receive afflictions, you know. And so you know, these are things that I've come to find out over the years. You know, the prophets had to go through afflictions in order to be worthy to write books. You know, Joseph had to go through afflictions before he could be elevated, or just different things. Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, David, Yehoshua even had to go through affliction on the cross to be raised to a greater glory. So when you follow what Yah has told you to do, you never know. Like, sometimes you don't see the fruit of it immediately. But now down through the years, 10 years later, this is going worldwide. And then after that, 7 years after this, the Most High allowed us to actually translate the book of Enoch from Hebrew into English. So these are things that, you know, when you're obedient, then he'll give you other things revolving around your gifts. So I want to inspire everybody to use the gift that the Most High put in you. You never know. We didn't know what this would be. We, at the time, we could have published the calendar and printed it at the time, but I didn't want to do it at that time.
But then I seen other people doing it, and then they was changing it. And then I said, hey, wait a second, we have to print this to preserve it, because otherwise it'll be forgotten. And then we started to print it, and everyone was always asking for us to print them out. But we just said, nah, it's here on the video. But then we start seeing other people do it, and it wasn't even given to them. And then they started to alter it. And then that's when the Most High said, go ahead and print them. And so that's when we started. And remember those days?
Gang.
Gang. Hallelujah.
The year of this whole clock, this whole circle represents an entire year. There are 12 months to a year, just like there are 12 divisions on every clock. So if we look at these each division as a month, the way to determine each hour would be by the hour hand. Okay, so we don't need the minute hand or the second hand to determine when the hour changes between one hour and the next hour. The main hand that we need to represent or use is the hour hand. And that's supported by scripture. Okay, let's go to the book of Jubilees. The book of Jubilees is a scripture that was written by
Toda Yakumia. Y'all bless you, brother. Thank you for the support. Appreciate that.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. And now, I told y'all, 7 years after Yah gave us a calendar, he allowed us to translate Enoch. Mm-hmm. Then 10 years to the date, he allowed us to translate Jubilee. We would have never done. This is nothing you could do of your own accord. So we just thank the Most High that we could share with Israel.
Moses, for those who are not familiar. And it is a book that describes everything that happens between the books of Genesis and Deuteronomy, but it categorizes everything by jubilees, which are 50-year time periods. And so it chronicles creation down to the Exodus and down to Deuteronomy by jubilee seasons. All right, so we're going to go to the book of Jubilees, and we're going to see what Moses writes concerning the year and when it begins, and how long the year is. Okay, we're going to go to the book of Jubilees, the 6th chapter. Bear with me for 1 second. We're going to go to the book of Jubilees, the 6th chapter, and we are going to start at the 28th verse. And in these verses, Moses writes and records exactly how long a biblical year lasts. Okay, this is the Hebrew calendar and how long it lasts, and we're going to see the difference between our calendar and the Gentile calendar. It reads Jubilee 6 and 28, and he's writing in reference to the year. And all the days of this commandment are 52 Sabbaths of days. So a year lasts, there's 52 weeks or 52 Sabbaths in every year. And the whole year is completed. Thus it is engraved and ordained in the tablets of heaven, and there is no transgression from one year to another. So right off the bat, there should be 52 weeks in every year. So that goes totally the Gentile calendar or the Gregorian calendar, they call it Julian calendar. All these different calendars go totally against scripture, because you have certain years that will have more than over 52 weeks in a year. Okay, and so that is against scripture. So we know that this Gentile calendar is off, being that it starts in January in the midst of the winter, when things are dead, the trees are dying, the grass. But our calendar, your Most High's calendar, starts in spring when life is renewed again. So let's see what else he says.
Hallelujah. Freck the girl. You can pick up the new 23-24 calendar on HebrewIsraeliteScriptures.com, and you click on here where it says shop, and this is the button for it, the 2023-24 official Enoch calendar. And this is what it looks like, and we have different images from the calendar here, pictures of Yehoshua, pictures of Jacob and his four wives representing a whole year divided into four seasons. That's what Jacob's family and their 12 sons represents, the Enoch calendar itself. So look at all of the revelation that first, since the original calendar came forth, and other people have brought forth, even like Brother Tyrone has brought forth about the rock, the stone the circular stone being rolled over the mouth of the cave sealed with seven seals. All these are different revelations that are being brought forth since this. But now you can go on HebrewIsraeliteScriptures.com and you can actually pick up the calendar today. Hallelujah. So let's go back to it.
And thou command the children of Israel that they should observe the years in this number, 364 days, and the year shall be complete. And the fixed date of their days and their festival shall not be corrupted. So we see here that the Hebrew calendar is actually 364 days long and not 365. So this Gentile calendar throws us way off and totally separates us from the commandments of the Most High God. And we're going to see it makes total sense. If the Most High God created the year to be 365 days, which is an odd number, we can never divide that year into four equal seasons, four equal time periods of the seasons. Each season and everything that the Most High God made is good. So even a season should be an equal length. Now, if you divide 365 into four seasons, you're going to get some crazy number, all right? And it always is off. And because it's always off, they add additional days to the year known as leap days or even leap years, where they add additional days to compensate for the additional day that the 365th day that they tack on each year. So it throws our count off if we go by that. All right, I'm going to read a little more. Okay. And the year shall be complete, and the fixed date of their days and their festivals shall not be corrupted. But everything transpires in them according to their testimony. And they, Israel, shall not miss a day or corrupt a festival. But if they do transgress and do not observe them according to his commandments, then will be corrupted all their fixed dates. And the years will waver in consequence, and also their times and their years, and they will transgress their ordinances. So when our people began to follow this Gentile calendar, and go by 365 days a year to do all of our festivals and feast days, okay?
Now, we just said how when Israelites, the scripture just said, when Israelites would follow what the heathen would say are the appointed times, they would err, right? And the Gentiles would speak words against the Most High and think to change times and laws. So this is what happened. I'm gonna break down the history of the calendar. So when this calendar came out, you know, certain Israelites started to adopt it, and many of the Gentiles started to adopt it. To be honest, the Gentiles adopted it faster than many of the Israelites, which was really surprising. But this is what happened. I told y'all that the midst of the week represents what day does the midst of the week represent? So equal what? Equinox, equal day and equal night. And that's always going to be on what day? Wednesday, right? That's what scripture says. That's when Yah created the sun, moon, and stars. So this is what certain Israelites started to do. And Casita, if you could point out, I'm going to pull up the information that you sent me earlier, okay? Okay. Actually, send it. Can you send it to this tablet and then I can pull it up from there? So what started to happen, this day is always going to fall during the midst of the week. You had Israelites who started Googling, asking Google, when is the spring equinox? And it's in Google or different websites, time and date and other stuff will say, hey, equinox is on Sunday. The spring equinox is on Tuesday this year. Matter of fact, the spring equinox is on Wednesday next year. And the year after that is going to be on Saturday. It's not pulling up. Okay, let me do it from here. Okay. I'm going to send it here, and then I'll open it on. I'll send it to my iPad. Share. Share to. Share notes. Oh. So instead of being obedient to what the Most High said, that is, he created the sun, moon, and stars on the midst of the week, they started Googling instead. And then they would go to certain websites, and the websites would say, hey, you know, the equinox is on Monday. So the people would say, oh, well, we're going to change the calendar, and we're going to make the equinox when time and date or whoever they went to start to say. So then they start shifting days, just like the Most High said not to do. And then you start having a million different calendars, right? So now, you know, we just watched. We just held our peace and watched what people would do, right? So now we're going to show y'all a lot of the date, the websites that people go to get the dates of the equinox, how they're going to show you from their own mouth that their count is incorrect. You have Israelites and Gentiles who would go to all of these different sites to find out when the equinox is. Instead of listening to what the Most High said, they literally did just what he said they was going to do. They're going to follow what the Gentiles and the heathen say. So I'm going to pull that up on the screen so y'all can see where things started to shift, okay?
All right, so this first link, it says, consider the year 2000 CE. For the case of the vernal equinox, we can first estimate the time at which this event takes place by approximating the solar longitude as the mean solar longitude. So,
and this is from astronomy.
No, this one's from the top.
Oh, Far Side. Okay, yeah. Go ahead.
This is the University of Texas website.
Kane, I remember that one. Mm-hmm. So break down what that means. Make it in plain terms for everybody.
Well, basically, and as you can find this on several other sites, the calculations that you're seeing now are based upon starting with the year 2000.
Facts.
So just think about that for a minute. If you're Googling and you're looking up these dates, they're starting from the year 2000, and there's this nice complicated formula, which, you know, we won't get into. And from there is how all of these dates of the equinox has been calculated. And it tends to fall, what you will see when you Google it, usually it says March 20th. Mm-hmm. Doesn't matter what day of the week it is, it's always March the 20th.
Right, no matter if it's Tuesday, Monday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. And they're telling you they approximate it. So people are taking the approximations of the heathen and replacing the true calendar of what it said. And then coming back, oh, we got the true calendar. Mm-hmm. When their calendars are based off of approximations, but they can't even discern what they've just done. Mm-hmm. So then Yah would just allow, he would just say, okay, well, here's the book of Enoch translated to show the people. So now we're showing you where people made their errors 10 years later. Okay, go ahead.
All right, so the next one is from astronomy website, and it says calculating the exact time of the vernal equinox.
The accuracy of calculating the vernal equinox, all right? This is from this site. Okay. Very important.
Calculating the exact time of the vernal equinox is essential for many ephemeris calculations. NASA's Goddard Institute for Space Studies uses, at least for some purposes, the following rather short source code. Keep going down. For a given year, vernal calculates an approximate time of vernal equinox.
What's approximate mean?
It's not exact.
So they're guesstimating.
Right. It's kind of like when you round a number.
You're rounding off. And people are going by what these sites saying above what the scripture said, the midst of the week. Okay. Go ahead.
For a given year, vernal calculates an approximate time of vernal equinox in days measured from 2000 January 1 hour 0.
So they start on January, their count, which is the dead of fall anyway. And at the year 2000, this is when they start in their count. And you got Israelites giving credence to that more so than what the word says. And then you have more deviations in the calendar. Mm-hmm.
Vernal assumes that vernal equinoxes from one year to the next are separated by exactly 365.2425 days.
So they're timing their vernal equinoxes and their summer solstices based off of a calculation of 365.2425 days a year. And then Israelites will come back, oh, well, your equinox day is wrong because this website said so-and-so. But they didn't bother to look at how they're calculating the time. And we never moved. And we stayed true to what Yah gave us. And 10 years down the line, look how he's perfected it. Go ahead.
All right, which is a tropical year.
Mm-hmm.
Explanatory supplement to the astronomical ephemeris. If the tropical year is 365.2422.
That's a different calculation than the first. So now they're saying this kind of year is going to have 365.2422 days.
As indicated by other references, then the time of the vernal equinox will be off by 2.88 hours in 400 years.
They're telling you their calculations got errors in it. But yet some of our people, they love Esau. Esau's ice is always colder. So this is what Moses said. They would follow after the heathen did. And then they would come with error. And then you had all of these different variations. We're showing you how this thing happened in the 10-year period as we watched. Okay. Go ahead. This is one of the biggest ones, right? Oh, I went to timeanddate.com. I know your calendar's off because time and date said such and such and such and such and such.
All right. From timeanddate.com. They're saying if you look at them, it says equinox, not equal.
Right. They never have an equal daylight and equal nighttime period. They say it never happens in nature. Mm-hmm. Doreen, Sister Doreen, we appreciate you. And y'all bless you. Toda Akoti. Y'all bless you. Y'all bless you. Y'all bless you.
All right. The day and night are only nearly equal on the September equinox and the March equinox.
It's never equal, only nearly equal. So I don't know who would even say that there's no such thing as an equinox, an equal day and night. But they would rather listen to what they say on their websites than to what the Most High said in the scripture. So man says, no, there is no equal set. Let's read that in Jubilees. No, was that Enoch or Jubilees where it said it would be equal day and night?
That's going to be Enoch chapter 72. Verse 32.
Toda. Let's go to Enoch 72. Let's see what the word says. Go ahead. You read that out.
Starting at verse 31. And on that day, the sun rises from that portal and sets in the west and returns to the east and rises in the third portal for 1:30 mornings and sets in the west of the heaven. On that day, the night decreases and it shall be 9 parts. And the day to 9 parts, and the night is equal to the day, and the year is exactly as to its days 364.
Okay, the night is equal to the day, and the year is exactly to its days 364. But time and date said, let's read what time and date said one more time. Oh, where was it? What was we reading that? No, that was notability. Okay, go. Yeah, time and date said, read that.
The day and night are only nearly equal.
It's only nearly equal. So when timeanddate.com tells you it's the equinox, what we say about the equinox is off because their equinox measurement is right because they're white and they say so. So then they would make calendars based off of what time and date said. Just like Yah told Moses they're going to follow the heathen. So when it was given, they went and altered it again.
Mm-hmm. All right. In fact, most locations on earth tend to enjoy more daylight hours than nighttime hours on these 2 days of the year. Mm. Thanks to the earth's atmosphere and our definition of sunrise and sunset.
Whose definition?
Our.
Whose hour?
Them.
Who's them?
Them.
Okay. It's what we say, right?
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Why his lips so chapped though, man? You zooming it in like bah.
Mm-hmm.
All right. More than 12 hours of sun. The next equinox is at 21:24 UTC on March 20, 2023. On this day, New York City residents will enjoy a 12-hour and 8-minute long day.
So on their equinox, it's not even 12 and 12, it's 12 hours and 8 minutes, which means the other has to be 11 hours and 52 minutes.
Yep.
That's their equinox. Mm-hmm. So if the daylight has 12 hours and 8 minutes long, that means their nighttime is 11 hours and 52 minutes. And Israelites will come to us and say, the equinox we have is wrong because time and date. And this is time and date telling you there ain't no equinox, according to them. And people literally... Some of the same people that was mentioned in this video came to me. Let me be quiet, man. Just forgive me, forgive me, forgive me. You got some people who would come and change what the word said. You know what I'm saying? Because of what the heathen said. We watched the whole thing unfold. And peace and blessings to everybody mentioned in the video.
Okay.
Kane, hallelujah.
All right, those in Amsterdam will get one more minute of daylight with a 12-hour and 9-minute long day. Even in Longyearbyen, one of the world's northernmost cities, the day will last for 12 hours and 25 minutes.
12 hours and 25 minutes. That's their equinox.
That's their equinox. Mm-hmm.
Which is miles will be 13 hours in 11.
Mm-hmm. Moving southwards, Melbourne in Australia will see 12 hours and 10-minute long day. Johannesburg inhabitants will also enjoy a similar number of daylight hours. On the South Pole, the sun will be up 24 hours, perfect opportunity to see the midnight sun. On the equator, the day is always a little longer than 12 hours all year round.
Dang. So this is how you started to have deviations. And then what started happening, people started shifting their days, and then they started making all new calendars, and then it's not even in our calendar anymore. And we watched it happen. And then the Most High would just give us another book to translate, you know. And, you know, sometimes you just got to show people in the language. So that's how Yah would have us do it. Just show them in the language. And instead of going back and forth with people, we don't want to do that. You know what I'm saying? We want to have peace within Israel. We don't want to have useless debate. So that's why the language becomes important, because when we can read it in the language, then that solves the problem. But then we started to see, well, not enough people really understand the Hebrew, because there was a lot of confusion about what Hebrew is and isn't, you know. So then Yah showed us, okay, you have to teach classes on the language to help people understand the language, you know. Then when they get the books, they can read for themselves. They don't need anyone to interpret it for them. They can read. And when we all can read our language, then we can grow that much closer to the Most High and to discerning the times. So that's a snapshot of how the calendar has come. All praise to the Most High. Yeah. And we wanted to share that with you. And we're grateful that Yah has given us a new year, and literally the 10th year from the restoration of the Enoch calendar. And with that, he's allowed us to release the Book of Jubilees. Hallelujah. At the 10th year. Hallelujah. And the 7th year, he allowed us to release the Book of Enoch itself, the first and second books of Enoch. And then the 10th year, he's allowed us to bring forth the Book of Jubilees in Hebrew and English. And now we have many people learning the language that they can read for themselves. All praises to Yah. So this is how the Enoch calendar has grown throughout the community. And even like we said, a lot of the Gentiles started to use the Enoch calendar, and this is the roots of the calendar. And we're grateful that we could share with you the special edition of the 10th year calendar. So let's show them one more time. I want you to explain these things to them, because see that as I pull this up so the people can understand.
Sister Cheryl Williams responded, you know, as to why the guy's lips so chapped. She said, they're chapped from speaking lies.
Dang. Facts.
talking about the picture you keep showing.
Kane. Facts. That's what they do. They got poison under their tongue. So that's what it is, you know? Let me share the screen.
All right. You are looking at the website, HebrewIsraeliteScriptures.com. Across the top, click on that button that says shop. And the first two items are our newest additions, the 2023-2024 official Enoch calendar and the pre-ordering of the Book of Jubilees. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Okay. And in these, we're going to pull up the Enoch calendar for this year, the special edition 10th anniversary calendar with the birthdays of the patriarchs and the martyrdoms of the apostles, and explaining Jacob as and his family as the calendar itself. We have information on the Maserot, which little Yadai Yeshua has drawn here, detailing Yehoshua in the center and the four seasons surrounding him with the 12 stars, the 12 constellations representing the 12 tribes of Israel.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. So now we're in the month of Aviv, and we have, read that again in Hebrew for the people, son.
Yehoshua HaMashiach.
Yehoshua HaMashiach came. Go ahead.
Kanoka Sofer.
Kanoka Sofer, Enoch the scribe. Okay. For the month of April, Iyar. Go ahead.
Yaakov with Esau.
Jacob and Esau, the month of May, representing Geminis, the two twins. And we'll show one more.
Kanoka Sofer with Shir Hama'ala.
With Sar.
Oh, Hama'alakim
Oreo. Okay. Kanoka Sofer, Enoch the scribe, with Sar Hama'alakim, the prince of the angels, or the archangel Uriel, as he's taking them through the portals of heaven, showing them the signs in heaven as Kano watches on. And that represents June and the month Tammuz. So we have all of these things with a load of information, scriptures, and this is the source from which all the Enoch calendars come. So this is available now as well as the Book of Jubilees. Hallelujah. I'm so excited about sharing Jubilees with everyone. So we have toiled very hard to complete the Book of Jubilees. All right. This is a special Paleo Hebrew edition of Jubilees. All praise to the Most High Yah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And no, those notes aren't on the cover.
Yeah, those notes aren't on the cover. Let me erase that real quick. But somebody say they got an error on their copy. Let me get rid of all that, right? So this is the Enoch, the Book of Jubilees. Again, telling the time of the last days, the times, the seasons, the days, months, and years. So we have the hourglass because time is almost at its end. So time is speeding up. So this is what is being shown here. And we have the Hebrew on the left-hand side. This is the Paleo Hebrew edition. So the name of Yah, the Most High, is in Paleo Hebrew. All praise to the Most High Yah.
Hallelujah.
All right. And then when we go across to the right side, we have it in English. And on the English side, again, we have words, the first time they're mentioned, we have the Paleo Hebrew, Strong's number. So Torah, the first time it's mentioned, means law. Hebrew word 8451. Jubilees, which is Yobalim in Hebrew, H3104. So we have all the Strong's numbers. Yah's name, Yehovah's name in Paleo Hebrew. All right, H4872. Moses, Moshe. H4872. So when Yah's name is mentioned, Paleo Hebrew. This is the Paleo Hebrew Gold Edition with precepts and with dynamic pictures, family. Dynamic pictures. Let me give y'all a sneak peek real quick.
Tori Jones for your super chat donation.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. And as Abraham,
Isaac, and Jacob, this is just a snapshot. Man, I love the pictures in this. We got the brotherly covenant that was broken, that's written about in the book of Yoel. He broke the brotherly covenant, Yaakov with Esau. Oh, man, look at that. I love this. Jacob and Esau. Oh, man. I mean, I can't show no more, family. This book is history. I'm going to stop here. But this book, I can't show y'all anymore, y'all. Y'all got to go get it. Go on the website now, www.HebrewIsraeliteScriptures.com. Get this book. You will not be sorry, man. And to the Hebrew students, y'all going to enjoy reading this in Hebrew. This is a one of a kind. You're not going to find this anywhere. But Torah, y'all, you can find it right here, okay?
And before you step away from that, I wanted to add a couple of things. Like I said, I can't say enough about how much the precepts being in there. You know, it's a great tool, especially if you're already familiar with the writings of Enoch and Jubilees. It's a great tool to be able to show friends and family, right? The Hebrew, learning Hebrew is a great tool to have to practice, because with it going from the center spine, your Hebrew reads as it should from right to left, and your English will read left to right. Also, the name of the Most High, Yahweh, being in the Paleo Hebrew, for anyone who researches, they'll know that this is one of the things that the scribes of old used to do. When they had switched over to the biblical Hebrew, they still kept that tradition of writing the Most High's name in the Paleo Hebrew. So the original form would never be forgotten. It's a lot going on here. You know, I know we went, you know, kind of long today, but I can't say enough about this Book of Jubilees and just the features, right? The features that you not even on top of that, you got the artwork, but the features that you get with it as a tool for learning, right? Yes. So just wanted to add that in there.
Okay. This has been a labor of intense love for the Most High, for the people, for the language. We put precepts in here. We put Hebrew. We put English. We put the true images of our people, of the Messiah, the understanding, the breakdown of the calendar. Blood, sweat, and tears went into this. And spiritual warfare on a whole nother level, you know, to resist against us putting this together. And the Most High blessed us to get it done. So we're just so grateful to the Most High Yah for all that he allowed us to bring forth in this season. Hallelujah. Did you want to say anything, Maury, before we get out of here?
He's muted.
Oh, you muted, Maury.
Can you hear me now?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, no, I was just saying, I think you said everything perfectly. But I just recommend, again, getting the calendar and Jubilees ASAP and start studying, because time is short. And there's so many gems to learn out of it and to study out of it, because we'd be teaching out of these things, and it's very powerful. Very, very powerful. Yeah.
Dang. All praise to the Most High. We're going to say a prayer. Blessed be thy name, Most High Yah. In Yehoshua's name, we come before you to honor you, to praise you, to worship you, to give you thanksgiving, to give you supplications, to give you the honor that you are more than worthy of. For the victory you have already obtained from the very beginning, we thank you, O Most High Yah. Thank you for this new year. Thank you for this new season. Thank you for the fruit that you have brought forth. Thank you for helping us to endure throughout the past year, Father, to bring forth, Father, your word in a form in which it has never been brought forth before, in Hebrew and in English, and showing the true images of our people, that our people might see themselves, Most High, even a labor to honor you and to honor your son, Yehoshua, the apostles, the patriarchs, the prophets, the matriarchs, and the holy people, to restore the language back unto the people, Most High, through
through fire and water. You've allowed us to make it through into a new year, and we just thank you, Most High Yah. You have been our rock. You have been our strength, O Heavenly Father. Even as the heathen attacked us, us greatly, O Heavenly Father, the heathen came heavily upon us. Continually, Most High, the heathen came against us to try to stop and try to discourage and distort and destroy the works of Most High Yah. But you helped us to endure in the midst of many fiery battles, Most High, and many testimonies that have yet to even be revealed to the people, the testimonies that you have brought forth in this, and the understandings and the teachings that will come forth out of this, and the word that shall go forth out of these things. We just thank you. And we just pray, Father, that you will bless all the people in the new year. We pray that you would rain down abundance from on high. We pray, Father, you will bless them with the blessings of heaven and earth. We pray, Father, that you give them wisdom, knowledge, understanding, and counsel. We pray you give them might. We pray, Father, you would give us a set apart spirit and even victory over the adversaries. We pray for healing in the body. We pray for strength in the body and in the spirit and in the mind. We pray, Father, for food, shelter, and clothing. We pray for mercy. We pray for compassion and forgiveness. And we pray, Father, again, for the healing and blessing and restoration of thy people and of thy name in Israel. We give you all the praise, honor, and glory. And pray, Father, again, for forgiveness and repentance and blessing in all that we do. In Yahushua's name we pray. Hallelujah. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Amen.
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 Man, we just thank y'all, family, for celebrating the new year with us and the first Shabbat of the new year. I want to thank my panel. I want to thank Maury over at Yahoo. Go ahead, Brother Tyrone. I want to thank you. Go ahead and blow the shofar.
You put me on the spot.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah to our family who's gathering with us for Pesach. Can't wait to see you. We're really excited about the gathering and the fellowship that's about to happen here in the ATL. So, continue to get yourselves ready. We're excited about this gathering. It's going to be highly blessed. So may the Most High bless you in the week ahead. And we look forward to y'all releasing some more videos later in the week. So y'all bless you and keep you till next time. Shabbat shalom.
Shabbat shalom. Shabbat shalom.
Hallelujah.